Okay. Did you start recording?
I am recording. It's go time.
Okay. Welcome to Band Camp, a campaign about a band. I'm Blade, the GM. I'm joined by Blaze Masterson.
I'm playing as Rhody, the Rhody.
Scoob.
Hello. I play a tiefling thief called Teeth.
Who steals teeth.
From beneath.
And then queef.
Nines.
What? No! Sorry.
Not nines.
Hello. I am playing Friendly Fire, a wingman, and roadie.
Universal.
I am playing Hawkins, a real wingman, because I'm a birdman, and a... What was my class again?
Ranger.
Thank you.
Ow. And Edward.
I am playing Ambrose, the dwarven sorcerer, and I am the bassist.
Okay, so the story is you've all just completed a big, epic, long adventure. And at the end of the adventure, you were teleported far, far away from your home.
Not horse roast.
So first of all, because you just you didn't have time to rest after right after the adventure. Anyone who is a spellcaster, use up one of your spell slots in each level.
Right here.
Oh.
And everyone roll. Let's see, how much do you need to roll? Roll a. Say 3d10.
Okay.
Nice. I got some crit fails in there.
Rolling. I got some crit successes. That's nice. A good thing, right?
Get him, Scoo. Scoo's in trouble. That's like half of Scoo's life.
Oh shit.
Yeah. You reduce your health by this much.
I mean, I've just been rolling so well lately. It's not really
good. The minimum you can have is 5 hit points.
Oh, okay. Sear.
Bummer.
I am hurt.
I'm about half.
Is that everyone roll? Where do I see? Oh, yeah, okay. Now, Hawkins,
yeah.
You were able to fly up and scout and see that there is a big, you recognize, like, a big mountain range. You recognize it as a mountain range that you saw is near your hometown.
Right. That is Horf Rust. Yes.
Horf Roast.
Yeah.
Right.
Sure.
Okay. I shall call down and tell them what I see.
Caw!
That's a happy caw.
Something else you see is right in front of you. There is a nice little village.
Oh, okay. Well, maybe I won't cacao.
Give us a quiet.
Nice. It's a nice little village.
Cacao?
Cuckoo.
I
for Cocoa Puff?
I'm from a mixed race bird family. So. Do I see, is it like, I don't know, Do I see people moving around, or is it just...
Yeah, those you see... something I forgot to mention is that you seem to be in a very, very cold climate. Everything is just snowy.
Okay.
And you see that, like, you know, the people are wearing warm clothes. They're walking around quite happily, doing villager stuff.
Okay. Well, this seems reasonable enough. I'll fly down. I'll tell them what I saw. And then I'll wrap my wings around myself for warmth.
Who are you telling what you saw? The villagers or us?
Everyone. No, everyone in the party.
Hello, villagers. I have seen you.
Let me tell you what I think.
Ambiguity is fun. Friendly Fire says, villagers, there might be cultists over there. Woo!
What? That's a lot to assume. Just
a lonely village nestled in the mountains, villagers doing village things. I suspect cultists. And where there are cultists, there are naive souls waiting to be converted to the true word of Trash Canosaurus, Rex.
Okay, so is this going to be like the start of Resident Evil 4? Only time will tell.
Can we tell from this distance if the people are sort of just behaving normally? What we would deem normal?
Well, you know, they don't seem to be behaving.
They're not like walking like zombies. Or anything. Yeah.
No, they're like walking around, talking to each other, quite like smiling a lot.
Smiling, we'll fix that. Where there's a smile, there's teeth.
Ah, I see.
You could start up some sort of dental practice in here and just...
Emphasis on practice, yeah.
Yeah.
Kind of a Sweeney Todd dentistry.
Yes.
You do notice that this building over here... Wait, can you see?
Can't see this one.
Yeah, the big reddish.
Oh, now I can see.
Is an inn, or appears to be an inn. And the other houses are just like, like homes, normal homes.
If I know anything about new villages, is that you've always got to go to the inn first.
If that's our inn, where is our out?
Boo.
whoa.
Rody the roadie is a practical man, and he realizes that if we have an inn, we should probably go ahead and take a little bit of a rest to recover our damage and our spell slots from our last adventure. So he says, let's get down to business. And he starts marching toward, toward the village. Inside
to
the inn.
Defeat.
Oh, that makes way more sense.
Yeah,
in private, and so he'll head toward the inn and say, "Let's get a good night's sleep before we head back to Horfrost in the morning."
To be clear, is that your Scottish accent?
No.
I mean, he sounded like it could have been.
I kind of gave up on that one.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah,
my accent. He has an implied Scottish accent.
Well, you don't want to get it wrong. It is the best accent. So I take it we're approaching. I'm going to approach just on land because I don't want to freak people out more than I have to.
Yeah, let's head on up.
Head on up. So do the villagers sort of react when they see
it? You notice that quite a few of them are sort of looking at you, but like they don't seem, they're still smiling, they seem quite friendly.
How long have these people been smiling for?
How long have we been able to see them? The 10 seconds it took to get from the tree line.
I walk up to someone and say, how long have you been smiling for?
The smile slowly fades. Mommy!
It's like a little kid. He runs away.
He picks on like the smallest
one.
You like peck at them with your beak?
No, I am going to be like just walking in town, totally relaxed, like I own the place. Yeah, waving and smiling to anyone who looks my way.
Yeah, I think that with the amount of damage we've taken, some of it would be visible. Like, I imagine that my knuckles would be bloody, for example. Like, my knuckles are just bleeding. From punching things.
Oh, all right, right.
Right. I was trying to figure out the best way to say it. Didn't your knuckles get toughened up during your monk training?
If you punch enough things, eventually they'll come apart. I learned this from boxers.
Yeah. When you were punching that razor wall, I mean, we were all impressed at how well they held up.
While the rest of us walk through the doorway. He's just punching the razor wall. I'll get us through it!
Well, you have to know that razors killed my family. So I've got a vendetta.
Jesus.
That's why he grows his beard long.
And so the legend was born.
Your family.
I'm assuming he's got a beard. I mean, he's a dwarf, family. Right?
I do not have a beard. I do, in fact, shave. I shave, and it's to spite the razors. It's to try and dull it.
To blunt them all.
Yeah, trying to get them all blunt.
He's not the roadie this man needs, but it's the one he deserves.
Can we get to this inn now, please?
All right, please.
Not yet.
How many villagers are here looking at us?
Well,
is it just like everyone in the village lined up staring at us smiling?
No,
or is it like five people that we can see?
I'm concerned by the way you're asking about them. Their formation.
Would you say they are more than 10 feet apart?
I don't know. Everyone else, everybody else latched on to the creepiness of the smiles. So I want to know how many people are smiling at us.
Precisely how many? Count them.
Well, the funny thing is that you might try to cast a spell at them and instead create a field of flowers.
You
see about 10 people walking around, and about 5 of them, or maybe like 7, are like looking at you, smiling.
Okay, I think that is normal so for
that's
villagers.
That's quite a high percentage.
Yeah. That's a normal number of villagers to be standing out, and then when they see strangers come in from the woods, they're friendly and smile.
Okay, yeah.
No one smiles at strangers. You know,
are they smiling at my bloody fists? Is this the thing that they're smiling at?
I bet, like, in Teddy's notes for this, he did not expect there to be, like, a 5 to 10 minute segment about the smiles. He didn't have enough material on the smiles. He just thought, we'll go straight to the inn.
All right. Well, I'm going to continue to the inn with...
I think you'll find the final boss is a smile.
Oh, man. I'll rue that day.
Is his name Killjoy?
Okay, so you enter the inn. There's a nice little guy standing at like a table, sort of cleaning glasses, saying hello.
So this guy can't betray us because he's nice. What is it? Is he a dwarf or a?
He's a human.
All right. Okay. I'll say.
Well met.
Hello there.
Hello. Would you like to stay the night?
Yes.
Of adventurers looking for.
We're tired from our travels and monster killing.
Oh, were there any unlit trash cans outside?
There were no trash cans.
They're all on fire already. I'm very tired good. From a day of punching razors, sir. I'd like a bed for the evening.
Yeah, what he said.
First, that would be 5 gold each.
5 gold? I've never handled money before.
What's money? I think I've got it.
Do we have a bard in the party, by any chance?
Yeah, I'm a bird.
Someone with like a... It doesn't one of the performer backgrounds let you play for...
I think our lead singer is a bird.
I might have that background.
Oh.
I mean, we're a band, so, you know. Theoretically, we shouldn't even need that.
Yeah.
Could we try and sweet talk him to get a discount?
I've got the by popular demand.
He says that
yes.
If you don't have enough, I guess I could go for one night.
Use the by popular demand.
That's very generous.
You do notice that the inn is empty, like except for this man.
Okay, well, I'm perfectly.
No audience. Damn
it. We'll draw them in.
Exactly. We're rock stars.
Okay, I'll tell you what. We'll make this your best night of the year. Because we're going to play. Not for any other reason.
So?
I'll just pay the money. I'll just pay the money and then go and wrap up my fists.
You're a very angry roadie.
Worst roadie. He's not even going to help us set up.
I'm really practical. Is kind of the main bent of the roadie.
Okay, I'll give him 5 gold pieces. I'm not a haggling type.
Yeah, I'll pay as well. I took some money like way back as well. So
fine.
Oh, hang on. I'm gonna use my divine knowledge. I'm gonna pray to the goddess Thera, and she's going to teach me to be proficient at persuasion right now. Just so that I can haggle with this guy.
That is a handy god.
I mean, he did say that he can.
He just said,
"If you don't give him free to speak there."
Oh, I mean, if it's free, then never mind.
The first night's free.
First night's free. That's how they get you. That's how they get you hooked.
So, here's the thing: you guys don't pay me enough, so I actually can't pay. So it's pretty good.
Well, we don't need to. It's just
exactly.
It's a free night. We have a free night. Let's just take it.
We have a free night, and there are smiles everywhere. And that's
this
the first
a lovely
half.
Town. Can we just enjoy it?
And that's the first half an hour of this session is discovering that there's smiles and there's a free night.
This is good.
There's nobody here because they're all out there smiling.
I mean, my 5 gold is already on.
I've planned for this because I don't actually have that much, so this is good.
All right. You can always plan for or assume there's going to be a lot of arsing about. Okay, I've given them 5 gold.
Can we rest now?
No, you don't need to. Yeah.
I already did it.
I'll use sleight of hand to take it back.
Okay.
Like,
your rage makes me so happy.
Despite all his rage, he's still just a tiefling in a cage. So, does he show us to our rooms?
Yes.
I mean, I take it we're going to be like literally taking up the whole inn by ourselves.
There's a room.
Oh, right. Okay. Okay.
Where's our token?
It's a big room. Looks smaller on the outside.
Whee!
Well, I don't need a bed. I'm going to roost. This is me on the ceiling.
This is my bed.
On the ceiling?
Yep.
Where's the door? Is that the door at the top?
Are there any rafters? Or, well, if not, I'm just going to lie in the bed. Okay.
Man, I don't like the look of Oddward's bed there. Shit's going to kick off in the middle of the night. And
I took the crooked bed.
Okay. So you're all going to sleep now. Yeah.
Yes, please.
Pile up my pillow underneath my blanket so it looks like I'm in the bed, but I actually go and sleep in the corner.
Oh my god. Question. Question. No, never mind. Nothing. I was going to ask if we had any of Irvin's skeletons around us, and then I realized Irvin's not with us right now.
Yeah,
he's kind of preoccupied.
You're sleeping like in the corner, just on the floor.
Yeah, I take it that's the door.
Yeah, that's the door.
I've seen Lord of the Rings. I know how this works.
Okay.
Seen Lord of the Rings, but I've forgotten how this works.
That's a candle.
Okay.
That's the best bit.
What is this arcane device?
It's burning, but slowly. Oh, it's got a light aura.
Cool.
Did anyone else just see the candle move? This might be a haunted hotel.
I have no time for ghosts.
Are there any unlit trash bins in this room?
For crying out loud!
It is entirely made out of wood.
I'm not going to find any trash bins anywhere, am I?
Yeah, that's a little bit of a health and safety issue.
I suspect I'm going to have to start making my own and just leaving them places.
Maybe do a little sidelining in the refuse industry.
Precisely.
Hang on, speaking of health and safety, should we blow the candle out and go to bed?
I think
so. Like, leaving it there.
I go and blow the candle out.
It actually got out.
I can't actually turn off that aura, so...
What kind of hotel is this?
You turn off the candle and it disappears.
Did you just steal that candle?
Okay, so you all get your long rest. You all refill the spell slots and your health to max. Now, can everyone give me a perception roll?
Right. Perception. If I can even see it. Yep. Oh, that's good.
I pray to the goddess Thera to give me proficiency. No, it's too late. Oh well. I'm pretty sure that as I'm asleep, like I can't really pray to Thera. So,
Friendly Fire and Rhodey, you wake up in the middle of the night to the sound of the door opening. You don't see anyone in the doorway. You don't see seems to have opened randomly. Okay.
I would like to get up and close the door.
Before that, can you both give me another perception roll with disadvantage? Because you've just woken up.
Oh, damn!
How do I roll with disadvantage?
Roll it twice.
Just roll it twice and you take the worst twice out of the two. My worst, with disadvantage, I got a 16.
Oh, that's some great rolls from everyone.
Okay, so you both, just before it jumps on you, you see something crawling on the floor.
Oh shit.
And then let's see.
Just jump on my pillow bed.
Do you see this?
No.
It depends.
What about this?
To see a ghost?
No.
Do you see this?
Still nothing.
Okay. How about now?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Okay.
That thing's grim. Oh, is that a pokey joke? A Jokemon?
I throw balls.
It jumps at you. It's gonna I have to make it do stuff. Let's see, what's your AC, both of you?
17.
If I roll a 17, does that mean you hit? I hit?
It's yeah. Yes.
Okay, so Blaze, you're gonna take it jumps at you, it bites your neck, it traps itself around it. You take 9 piercing damage.
Okay, I'm gonna start punching the wall. It's wrapped around my throat, right? So I won't be able to yell.
Yeah, and okay.
I'm gonna punch the wall to wake everybody up.
No, everyone, you already wake up because you wake up from the bite that each of you get from one of these creatures.
Oh, shine a light. Okay.
Okay, 9 damage.
Except Friendly Fire, who dodges out of the way.
Woo!
Does that mean let me roll damage for each of you. So
because we were sleeping, there was no AC stuff going
on. Yeah, you couldn't.
Yeah, you can't dodge. Yeah.
Okay. Shit, how do I... Okay.
How much damage did we take?
He's rolling for that.
Oh, okay.
Separately.
Yeah. Do you take 9 damage piercing? Universal, you take 11.
Ow!
And Screw, you take 13. And they all... Same as with Blaze, they wrap themselves around your neck, still with their teeth still in your neck.
Okay, I roll over and say 5 more minutes.
Okay, everyone roll for initiative.
Ugh.
Oh, yeah, you have to click on yourself. One day I'll remember that. 22.
Cloaker.
Oh, shit. Oh, well.
Now we can look them up.
Not that much.
Does this cloaker have Hawkins by the cloaca?
Yeah, all of these do, except for who was it? Friendly Fire, who dodged out of the way.
Friendly,
so how comfortable? Can we get the turn order up? There we go.
Friendly, does this work? Fireball us.
Yeah, and then there should be an option to organize them by
descending.
Oh no, ascending.
Everyone can see everything fine on the turn order.
Yep,
turn order GD.
We still got goblins and corgi riders.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, there we go.
They followed us. No.
Jay-Z, I underestimated you.
Get them, boys.
Okay, so Hawkins, you're with this thing around your neck.
Yeah, I take it I need to sort of wrestle it off before I can do anything.
Yes.
Okay. Well, why don't I do that?
Do you want to think? Give me an unskilled. You can attack it technically, try and wrestle it off.
Right. Well, I'll try and throw it off. I sort of want to...
Okay, so that's an unskilled strength.
Strength. Okay. Wait a second. Where is strength? How do I roll strength?
Unskilled strength roll is at the bottom of the skills. No, that's a saving throw, which is different.
Right.
But that said, if you're not proficient in strength saving throws, then that's the same result.
Right. No, but, I am.
Okay, so
that'd be 8.
Yeah, I think our proficiency bonus is 3 at level 7.
Yeah. Okay. 8 is my actual.
Okay, so that's 8. and it's going to be a contest. So he is going to roll see how much he has.
75.
you succeed.
Yay!
You take him off of you. He drops to the floor in front of you.
Okay. Can I use my secondary attack to actually attack him?
You have extra attack, do you?
Yeah, I get like two attacks every turn.
Then sure. Let's say that throwing them off of you counts as an attack action. Okay.
Right, I shall whip my sword out and try and basically pin him to the floor.
Okay, you hit. And
6 damage.
You pin one of its wings to the floor with your arrow. Okay. Next, friendly fire. You don't have a cloaker around your neck.
Yeah. I could fireball this entire room.
Wooden structure!
But I suspect that though this would get me noticed and grant me the attention that I so desperately desire from my friends, that it would not be the best type of attention. So instead, I'm going to whip my hair around and channel divinity. Radiance of the Dawn, and create an explosion of holy light that harms only my enemies, everyone within 30 feet of me.
Look at you.
You have grown as a person.
Well, that's your whole character arc. I guess we're done here.
You're going to die in this episode.
They have to make a constitution saving throw. A constitution saving throw. If they succeed, they take half damage, which is 10 radiant damage. If they fail, they take 20 radiant damage.
Okay, so I think I'll just roll for everyone. Now, what's your DC?
I believe it's 14.
Okay, so they succeed. All of them. They take half damage. Okay, now, because they are wrapped around your neck, you guys take half of that. And they sort of transfer half the damage to you, to anyone who has a cloaker wrapped around their neck.
I would also like to move to the doorway, if that's possible.
Yeah, you should have a move action.
You would take a attack of opportunity from that cloaker. Unless you take a careful step.
Whichever direction he steps in, though, there's one nearby. Unless he goes straight back towards the rear wall.
I think he can position himself around the cloaker without provoking attacks of opportunity. I think that it's only when you remove yourself from their range entirely. So I think he can dance around it and go to like this square, which isn't... Yeah, and then to this one over here.
That's the radiant damage they take?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so...
So could I move to the damage door without provoking an attack of opportunity?
Yeah, sure.
Sorry, how much damage are we meant to be taking?
You all take 5. Anyone who has a cloaker wrapped around their neck, which is Skoo, Blaze, and Odd.
I would say that would provoke an attack opportunity, because you're moving through protected squares. That's my really reading of the rule, but you know. You can take a little hit.
I don't want it to hug me, though.
It's not great, no.
You could take a step straight backwards onto the pillow. That end.
I will take a step backwards straight onto the pillow. Bold move.
And now you can shimmy to the left and straight up.
To the left, to the left.
This one looks like a really cool headpiece that Teef is wearing.
I've got the flap up so I can see where I'm going.
That's your turn.
Yes.
Next. Everyone with a cloaker on their face takes. Let's see. You take 7 damage. Poison damage.
I am, as a dwarf, I am resistant to poison damage, meaning that I take half. So that's 3.
Is that true for me as well?
Yes, sir. It is.
Is it all dwarves?
Okay. All dwarves. All dwarves.
And you do start to feel sleepy.
I already was sleeping.
We were asleep.
Yeah, you start to feel even more sleepy.
Okay, maybe I will fireball the room next turn.
That'll keep us awake at least.
I was also considering just activating Mr. Big Poops and breaking the floor.
Mr. Big Poops, activate. All right, is that their turn, Ted?
Yeah.
Ooh, that makes it my turn. I'm going to use...
Fundraisers.
Oh, actually, no, wait. Forgot the ones that aren't on people. This one comes up to you, Friendly Fire, and it attacks you with its tail.
No!
Never a tale of more woe.
What's your AC?
17.
Okay. It does hit you. You take 6 bludgeoning damage. Ugh. And the one near Hawkins is going to moan. instills fear in all of you.
That doesn't normally instill fear in me.
Great and powerful DM, could you RP that moan, please?
Wait, I'll use the voice for this.
Hold on. Let me get my trousers off. Oh. That was actually good.
Yeah. Did you get your trousers off in time?
No.
Okay, so how do I... What does that do to me? Do I have to roll against...
Everyone... Yeah, everyone... I think this hits everyone. Let's see. Yeah, it does for sure hit everyone. Make a wisdom saving throw.
Bam! 22.
Ooh, me too.
Oh boy.
You guys are so wise.
Okay, so Odd and Friendly Fire. No, wait, not Friendly. Blaze, you are frightened. Let me check what that actually means.
I was just going to ask, what does that mean?
Let's see. Frightened. A frightened creature has disadvantage on ability checks and attack rolls while the source of its fear is within line of sight. The creature can't willingly move closer to the source of its fear.
And the source of our fear is this one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You should still be able to deal with the one on you. With the disadvantage.
Yeah.
Just turn right.
Yeah, I was thinking maybe face the wall, but that's not good role playing, right? You wouldn't like be like, oh my god, I'm terrified of this thing.
Just walk backwards.
Yeah, like come on.
I'll say that. Blaze,
headbutt the wall.
Friendly fire is blocking your line of sight.
Oh, that's sweet. Thank you. Friendly, you're so big and nice and friendly.
You can fire through me. I won't take it personally.
No, I'm
especially
not.
Since.
No, you're my friend. I'm gonna rip this like bug off of me and throw it to the ground and then stomp on it. And so I think that's. I think that's.
Reactions.
A strength check. Well, no, it's a strength check, and then to get him off of me, and then he's on the floor, and then I stomp on him.
Well,
like
you
a
said
fucking
to throw him.
The strength check. Here, I'm just gonna do the strength check. Don't give me any crap. All right, so this is contested, Ted.
Yeah, you rip it off. It's on the floor.
Okay, I'm gonna step on it with my fists.
You have extra attack.
I have extra attack, yes.
Do you also have hands for feet?
Yes.
You indeed hit it.
All dwarves do.
8 bludgeoning damage.
I just stomp on it with my extremely nice shoes that I guess I wasn't wearing because it's bedtime. So I guess I just kick the shit out of it. I stomp it the way that, like barefoot, and it really grosses me out a lot to touch it.
Is that the end of your turn?
And the title of your sex tape.
That was not a good one, Scoop. Let me see.
It grosses you out to touch it? Come on, that was great.
Oh, I can take a bonus action when I use the attack action and do another unarmed attack. My martial arts class feature. So I'm gonna stomp on it twice. I doubt
it fades.
Very well. All right, that is my turn.
Teeth.
Try your martial arts on them.
I'm going to try to wriggle out of this with some sort of acrobatic flippy thing, if that's okay.
Yeah, sure. I guess you'll contest its dexterity and
So unskilled dex.
Yeah, good rolling.
Oh, you just get it.
Okay, and then it's can I take a step back?
Sure.
To here, I want to attack this one. That's between Roti and I. With my rapier.
Well, actually, are you in half of your health?
Yep. Well, thereabouts.
Okay. Well, sorry, but let me just check what happens. I think you fall unconscious.
Oh, great.
Good night, Scoo.
Catch you later, guys.
Just fall asleep. Sleepy poison.
That's not ideal.
It isn't.
Yeah, you should probably get that thing off of him. I guess you can try and wake him up.
I only know one way to fix this problem.
So, is it me?
Yeah.
All right. I have two questions. One, I've got this thing wrapped around my neck. It's flapping around in my face. Does that break line of sight with the one that frightened me?
No. It's around your neck.
Second question, I've got this thing around my neck. Does that mean I cannot cast spells that have a verbal component?
No, it's not strangling.
Okay. In that case, pardon me, I will cast Shocking Grasp on this one that is in my face.
Okay.
Do be warned.
Oh, and I guess I have...
oh boy.
Disadvantage on this because of frightenedness. So, 15, but the first damage.
Okay. Let's see, does that hit?
Yeah, it does. Fess up.
if remind me again what happens.
If it's the same, it does hit. Yeah, it is successful. Okay. If it's the same.
It does hit. You take 5 lightning damage.
I take 5?
Yeah, because it's wrapped on your neck and you've just shocked yourself.
But it came from me. This spell is always involving touching the person.
Yeah, but it's wrapped around your neck. And...
Okay.
You've made a circuit.
You said how many?
You take 5.
5?
Yeah. Because it takes half of it rounded down.
Since I am... That put me under half my health. Since I am resistant, am I awake?
Or half of what rounded down?
Half of the damage? Like 9?
No, it's 13.
No. Oh, it's 13. Oh, shit. Ooh. Okay, you take even more.
Oh, shit, sorry.
That's fine. I mean, it's like 1 more.
That's true. If you die by 1 hit point, though.
No, I just fell under half my hit points. So does that mean I'm asleep, or does my resistance to poison keep me awake?
Oh, man.
You have resistance to poison?
Yeah, because I'm a dwarf.
Okay, sure.
No, put him to sleep.
You're still awake. still awake.
I don't want anyone to see my reaction to the situation. No one must know my dark ways.
I guess I should have ripped it off my neck before shocking it.
How many hit points do you have, by the way? Total. What's your max?
Me? 40.
40. Okay, so I can't one-shot you. That's good to know.
That's... You're right. Okay, sure. Hawkins.
Okay, so could I move here, sort of fly over, and try and wake up Skoo, or Teef, sorry?
I think unless you have, there is a trait that you get that that some flying creatures have that they don't take attacks for opportunity when flying.
Oh yeah, no, I'm gonna risk the attack opportunity, but I do have a feat, being a ranger, that I get. Advantage or disadvantage to the attacker on attacks of opportunity.
Okay, sure.
That is what
I'm going to do. You're going to move like this?
Well, like to here.
Okay, so you're going to probably oh no, or are you? No, you're not. Are you?
It's
only when you move this one. No, it's only when you move out of range. So if he moves with
no, it's not. It's not its range. It's you fine. Move out of. Out of range, it's that you move through a square. So moving or move out of a square that's protected. So these squares around him are protected. So I get an attack of opportunity there. And I would get an attack of opportunity after moving out of this one and into this one.
You if can you like move like this and this.
True. And actually, that's even better. Yeah, I'll move like that.
Okay, so it's gonna keep an attack opportunity with disadvantage.
Yeah.
It doesn't hit, I'm guessing.
My AC is 16?
Yeah, it doesn't hit.
Okay. Okay, and with that, I get close to Teef's ear and go,
Huh?
Huh?
Does that work?
Yeah, she wakes up.
Hey.
Is it morning already?
Is that going to be your turn?
Can I make a secondary my secondary attack?
I think that waking somebody up does not. It's
if I can make two attacks, then I will happily make two attacks.
Do you get the second attack from extra attack?
Yeah.
Then no.
Okay. Can I make one attack?
No, you've used up your.
Right. So that's my attacking action. Okay, that's fair enough.
Yeah.
Okay.
So now it's friendly fire.
Okay. I have a question. I'd like to understand why every time we do damage to these cloakers, that they also do damage to our friends. Is that just because they're occupying the same space, or is it some special cloaker thing?
It's a special cloaker thing.
Okay, so how comfortable is everyone with being burned into unconsciousness?
Wonderfully so.
No, why not?
Yeah.
I'm flame resistant, and I can dodge at the same time, I think.
Okay, I would like to risk an attack of opportunity and run through the door and toss a fireball behind me.
Sure.
So long.
I realized, you know.
What's your AC?
17. After 6 seconds of watching my friends suffer, I realized that, you know, I should take that hit to my reputation for their sake.
After watching your friends suffer for so long, you realize, I just don't care.
So you do that?
Oh, yes. I was waiting for you to roll the attack.
Yeah, yeah, it misses.
Oh, sweet. Okay, well, I'm going to cast Fireball now, everyone. Centered on the center of the room.
Wait, are you out of the room now?
Yes. My range on the spell is 150 feet, so.
Safely within the room, then.
Safely outside of the room. And kaboom! Everyone make reflex saves!
Oh shit, not again. Well, I wasn't there for the first one. Okay, let's see. What do we have to...
Wonderful. Yes! Good. Not our sorcerer.
And because I dodged, this kicks in, so I take no damage.
Sweet.
Evasion.
Which was really useful.
So... Everyone who saves takes half damage, which is 14 fire damage. Anyone who doesn't takes the full 29.
I have dropped to zero.
Ooh! As a bonus action, I would like to also cast Healing Word on my dropped companion to make sure he's still alive.
Okay, I take it that 12 doesn't save, by the way, yeah, no.
It does not, no. So, so you're actually at 5 hit points, please, not 0.
Woo!
Yeah, so it's fine.
Yeah, it means I can fireball again.
Oh, is there a window I can just jump right out of?
Is it fine or is it fire?
Can anyone remember what this was the cloaker's
AC?
Initiative.
16.
Okay. because I just deleted the cloak which I used to add to which I added to the.
I think that means they don't get to go.
That's law.
Right so, there. what was their reflex save? Did they? Are they all dead now? Because that would be sweet.
Two of them died.
Yeah,
that's pretty good. Small price to pay.
Only three of your friends.
The two that weren't wrapped around people's necks died.
Yeah.
So I should do the same thing again.
How do I add something to the turn order?
Maybe something
without rolling
else.
Oh, there we go.
Yeah, there's like a little gear you click on.
16. Add. Okay. 16. There we go. Okay. That's your turn.
That was my turn, yes.
Okay. Cloakers, Teeth. You take, let's see.
Oh, hold on. Did I get 5 health then as well? Because I forgot to add that. Or is that specifically aimed at someone?
That was specifically aimed. It was not a mass healing word. Okay. It was just a, yeah. You're still up though, right?
Yeah, yeah. I didn't take any damage. I dodged it.
Look, as long as you're conscious, you get no healing.
Well, you know, the way things are going, that won't be long.
Your combat effectiveness is not reduced at all by having low hit points.
You both take 9 poison damage.
Jeez. Okay, I'm at 0 again. Oh, wait. Hold on. No. Dwarf, I'm at 1.
See, oh, that's
you fall unconscious. Odd.
Oh, okay.
Is this poison from an attack, or is it just like what? How is it applying
it's
this?
Because
damage?
It's teeth still inside your neck.
So what I mean is, I'm not able to dodge that because it's in there.
No. Yeah.
Okay.
I'm looking forward to the cloaker teeth maracas.
How much health are you on, Chief?
11.
Yeah, okay.
Sure. My health bar is accurate now. I've updated.
It's just I can't actually select you because you have a cloaker on you. Okay. Right. I have to do other stuff. This one. Wait, let's just. Slash. See? No. Okay, so it's gonna walk up to you, Hawkins, and it's gonna attack you with its tail.
Is the inn on fire right now, by the way?
Yes. You should probably get out within the next 4 turns. It does not hit you.
Hey!
I can hear a dog snoot.
That's everyone, I think. Yeah, Brody.
Blaze, is your dog snooting the mic?
No, I have had my mic muted. I think, hopefully.
I'm gonna have
it is
a
your
cookie.
Turn now.
It is my turn. I'm ready to
try. That means one of us sounds like a dog.
Don't we all? Okay, so I'm going to run over here and start just punching Odd in the neck.
Me in the face.
Repeatedly.
Why don't you just peel it off him? Then hit it.
I want to punch him.
He's going to take damage. He's got 1 health.
Okay, I'll peel him off. I'm going to rip this thing off my buddy's neck. And isn't that silly?
Strength.
Ooh. Ooh.
Big man.
Bang. You just throw it out the window.
Yeah. I throw it into some flames. Think about that.
You do.
Cool. I'm going to use my extra attack to attack him with my fists, which are also my feet. And then I'm going to use a bonus action to do that same thing again.
It's dead.
If it's not dead, which it is. Good.
It's dead.
Okay, I've got a bonus action that I can use. Who is awake right now? Is everybody awake still? Are we good?
I'm asleep.
You're asleep?
Yeah.
Give him a little friendly slap.
I think you'll wake up because it's no longer in your system.
Yeah, I'll just shake him, I guess. I don't know. Okay, as long as we're all awake, I think that will be about the end of my turn. Alternately, actually, I'm going to use the rest of my movement to get over here and just provide these cloakers with more people they can hit apart from Scoo.
Okay. Thief. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to try to wriggle out of this one again, I suppose. Which was dexterity. Is it unskilled? It's unskilled, isn't it? Where has it gone? Yes!
Oh, nice.
Let's see. You succeed. Yeah. Actually, it rolled a 1. What should happen? Let's say you attack it. You throw it on the ground and attack it. So give me an attack.
I get that one. Ugh.
It misses.
But I can do my normal attack now, right? Because that was an extra one.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well, let's try that again. Ho-ho! There it is!
You do have extra attack, right?
No.
Chief.
That's a crit.
Then you don't.
Oh, sorry. Okay, I thought.
Because the make throwing them off counts as an attack.
Okay, then do I get my sneak attack? Because I'm within range of.
Sure.
Okay, so we'll forget that last one and I'll do my sneak attack.
Wait a second.
Wait, no, I don't, because I.
Yeah, I think the sneak attack only happens.
Yeah, on forget it.
Another attack.
Yeah, I don't think that again.
You missed. So
yeah. Okay, forget that. Okay. At least I got to click the button.
You've woken up.
And waste a crit.
Yay. Okay. I'm going to move over here by the door. And I'm going
gonna
to
shut it on friendly fire. So
no, I'm going to leave the door open so he can see all the flames that he's caused. I'm going to cast Witch Bolt on the one by Hawkins.
Yeah, but which bolt are you going to cast?
This one.
Brilliant.
And
I'm
going to...
What?
I'm going to roll for wild magic.
Yes!
Fireball, centered on yourself.
Summon Cloak.
No!
Oh, God.
Oh, no! Okay.
Christ.
Oh, roll on the wild magic.
Brilliant.
Oh no, that's a high number.
For the next minute, all of my spells with a casting time of 1 action have a casting time of 1 bonus action.
Nice. Ooh.
All right.
Nice.
Actually, next how much?
For the next minute.
Okay.
Do you have any spells that will put out these fires?
Probably not. I can make the illusion that there's no fire.
That's good enough. Take a look and see what you can come up with in the meantime. I am looking through my entire character sheet trying to figure out some way of not burning this into the fucking ground.
So I have used the witch bolt on this one.
Yeah, it misses.
It misses? Okay, but now I do have bonus actions. All my spells count as bonus actions. So I'm going to cast it again. And...
Isn't Witch Bolt a concentration spell?
It is, but you can drop concentration. Missed, so... Yeah, it missed, and you can drop concentration to do another spell.
Got it. Sweet.
So I will cast it again. Sweet.
Which bolt was that?
Oh, come on. It's because I have magic.
You hit Hawkins instead.
Fuck.
No wild magic. Nope.
Bummer.
Okay, what do I take?
You 6 lightning. Well, I'm guessing you cancel that immediately after.
Yes.
You're really lightening up my day.
No.
Okay.
That's it.
So many. Okay, who's most hurt?
I think Oddwood.
Me and Scoo.
Yeah, it might be Odd or Scoo, yeah. I'm still pretty healthy.
I have 1 hit point.
Okay, I think I might try and heal you for some reason. So I have a cure wounds spell that I can use. And I will. So, or should I just attack? What do you think?
I think you should attack. We're almost done with the cloakers. Odd should just leave. Frankly.
Bye now.
It's time for us to evacuate the room. Odd needs to get the fuck out. Let's stop these guys and then try and figure out some way of suppressing this fire, if there is such a way.
Okay, I am going to take my sword, and I am going to use it on the cloaker in front of me. It's a genius maneuver. Oh, crap, there's fire. Okay, so...
Where did these red worms come from?
Looking at that. Take it that missed.
Okay, hold on. No, I'm going to bend luck. So I'm going to spend 2 sorcery points.
See.
So I've got 2 attacks. The second one did hit. I take it.
You're attacking this one?
I would like to modify the first one.
Okay.
So I'm using bend luck. So I'm going to spend 2 sorcery points to roll 1d4 as a bonus to your first roll.
14 hit?
It still misses.
Oh.
But the second one hits and it shrivels up and down.
Hey.
I think. I didn't actually check, but it was on low health, so I think 6 killed it.
It definitely died. The fire would have got it as well.
Okay, is it your turn?
I think that is it, because, I made 2 attacks. I suppose I could move, but is there a window here? Or is it just...
There's a window here and here.
Right. Maybe opening the window at this point would be...
No, that wouldn't make any sense. There's a window here and here.
Is there a large body of water outside?
No. If there is, then it's sort of frozen.
I'll take a free action and yell out to everyone, start the fire brigade. Everybody grab your buckets, get in a chain. I'm going to yell as loud as I possibly can so that the citizenry know about this.
What if the citizenry... sent the cloakers.
Then they probably still want to keep their inn, so let's just do our best. We'll figure it out later. A building is burning, and that's dope for you, but this innkeeper might not be too pumped about it.
We're talking about a man's livelihood here.
Yeah, I think the innkeeper is not a follower of Trashcanosaurus Rex, and so not chuffed about his building being up in flames.
Not yet.
What if he just joins the band? He wasn't getting a lot of customers anyway.
Yeah, but we can't keep hiring people.
Hang on, so maybe he killed all his customers. That's why it was empty.
Yeah. Let's not stay at Cloaker Inn.
Well, yeah, was this inn named something like the Cloak and Dagger? Be honest, swear to me.
Yeah.
You didn't see any signs.
For didn't, look. Didn't see the sign that says certain death. B&B.
B and D E A D.
B and D and D.
B and D A D, Dad. Hey, Dad.
Oh dear. So.
Okay, so the cloaker has listed a turn of 32, and I that's just a weird thing that Roll 20 does sometimes. But I suppose that thing goes next.
Oh yeah. When did that happen?
It just happens when you rotate through time. The turn order twice. It will usually add its own initiative to itself and double it, and that's real weird.
Hmm.
I've struggled with that myself.
Okay, so now it's friendly fire.
So we just have the one cloaker left.
Yeah, it seems like a situation that calls for fireball.
I seem to always hear that voice in my head for some reason.
Is the door closed?
It's because I'm role-playing Trash Canosaurus Rex.
Ah, the dulcet tone.
Role-playing Trash
Canosaurus. Well,
what's
I don't
the range
know.
On fireball.
150 feet.
It's anywhere you want to go, baby. Fireball's there.
I don't have line of sight anyway, so AoEs are the only things that I could really contribute damage-wise. And it goes next. Is that correct?
You can't go into...
Yeah, you can walk into the room.
Oh. Oh, yeah. All right. That's a fair point well made. Okay, there I am. I am going to move up onto this pillow because it's nice and soft. Makes me feel safe. Now I will cast Scorching Ray at this cloaker, who is really the biggest threat to my friends in this room.
And who also coincidentally looks like a ray.
So... this requires 3 spell attacks, so I'm just going to click on the spell 3 times and see what it gives me.
Why does it require 3 spell attacks?
Because each ray has its own attack.
So it's 3. Okay.
So I crit on one of them, and the other two are 11. Hits
and it burns to flames.
17 fire damage. Wha-bam!
Okay, all cloakers are dead. You're out of combat. The room is slowly burning.
Do we have any way of putting it out?
Is there a well nearby?
Well.
Ugh.
If there is a well within 30 feet...
I go downstairs.
I mage hand the bucket.
If there's a well, there's a way. You did remember seeing a well outside.
I would like to evacuate, yes.
Leave.
I go downstairs to complain.
Everyone
to
on the square.
That my room is on fire.
Oh, there is a.
You do. As you get down, you don't. First of all, you notice that the entire building is starting to. Go on fire, and you notice that the innkeeper is no longer in the inn.
Hey. I'm yelling at the top of my lungs for the citizenry to assist.
No one told us this was an in and out.
Everyone,
I would
wake
like
up!
A refund.
Wake up! Damn you!
Outside, you don't see anyone.
What if the cloakers got them first?
Completely deserted.
You see, this is what I'm telling you about smiling villagers.
The villagers are the cloakers.
Oh my god.
Hold on. There were 7 smiling and there were 6 in there.
The cloakers will attack us anytime soon.
Where are the cloakers smiling?
Still one more. No.
Okay, should we check like a house? Should we just go and bang on the door, see if anyone's there?
You do notice that there is a house. This one has its door open, but there's no light.
Which one?
On
top or bottom?
This one.
The screen is too big. I can't actually zoom out.
Top.
Okay. Oh, I can zoom out all the way. Okay. We'll run up to this one, if that's the one. Still missed it. Because I'm a goober.
Yep. I shall go with.
Wake up!
Do any of you want healing?
Always.
Yeah, I could burn a healing spell on someone as well.
Did, you mentioned at one point that you were going to try to heal someone. Did you do that, or did you do something else?
I didn't do it, but okay, yeah, I can now.
I was just trying to remember if I missed.
Okay. Let's see. So, yeah, I'll go for cure wounds. Let's see. How do I display this again? Like that. Okay. So I shall cast that on Oddward, and I'll cast it as a second level spell as well. So you get 2d8 plus whatever my spell casting modifier is, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so you roll the 2d8, and I'll see what my thingy is.
Yeah, no idea what it is for rangers, but it's going to be one of your attributes plus your proficiency bonus.
I suspect it's wisdom.
Probably. That sounds about right.
4 hello. Plus 3 is 7. Oh, hello.
Well, miss.
Hello.
Not much. We're just deciding what spell to use.
Okay.
So I am casting a level 2 version of Cure Wounds on Oddward. He rolls 2d8 and gets 7 on top of that. Or do I roll 2d8? I don't know.
You do it.
I do it.
Plus your spell casting ability modifier.
10 plus 7, 17.
Excellent.
Okay. Oh.
Who was that?
Hold on.
That was odd. Okay.
Who's dropping?
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, Ted.
Is everyone here, Scoo?
Mm-hmm.
Lots?
Mm-hmm.
Aunt, can you talk?
Hey, I'm on my phone now.
Oh.
My computer reconnects.
Huh. I see. You get 17 back, I think. Oh, no, you don't. Well, maybe you do. I don't know. Maybe you get 20 back. There we go.
Okay, so what did I miss?
17 back.
17, all right.
Do you add the proficiency bonus to that?
For your spellcasting modifier? I believe so.
Okay, that's great.
I think spellcasting ability modifier is 8 plus your proficiency plus your modifier.
Oh,
that's
I'm
the
not
saving throw. That's the saving throw. The DC.
Oh, that's the saving throw.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's going off my wisdom. So that's 4, and the proficiency bonus is 3. Except actually, I don't have proficiency, so it's 4. 14.
If you can
you always
spells,
had the bonus in, I think.
Yeah, if you can cast spells, I'm pretty sure you're proficient in spell casting, like as a matter of course.
Okay.
I think so. I might be fibbing, but in the end, that's only 3 points. So let's keep going.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll do our best and figure it out next time.
Well, you. Does anyone else want to heal?
I just want to kick down this door. I'm busy trying to save the day.
It's wide open.
Okay, I'm going to close it and then kick it down.
So you're not really that interested in saving the day. You're more interested in kicking down the door.
Well, I'm into punching razor walls and kicking down doors. We've established these characteristics of Rhodey. So yes, I'm going to kick down the open door and then ransack the house looking for living beings. Wake up! Wake up! Wake up!
While stealing golden jewels.
I don't need to steal golden
the
jewels.
The house is seems to be... It's very dark. Does anyone have dark vision?
I do.
Dwarves do.
I do as well.
Yeah. So most of us do.
Okay. So whoever does, you notice that on the table there is something slightly glowy.
I grab it as I look for people. I toss it to I grab it and then I toss it to Odd and say, magic that.
Okay, Odd.
It explodes. It was a hand grenade.
It seems to be a rod with odd symbols on it. And as you...
Screw you, ruin you, that shit for me, you bastard.
As you hold it, you feel...
It's just Oddwood's odd rod.
You feel like your mind is like expanding.
Whoa.
Ooh.
It's got some trippy drugs going on here.
And you are now able to telepathically communicate with anyone within 30 feet.
Oh, goodness.
Awesome.
Who said that? did you guys hear that?
You don't find anyone like in the house. What you do find is a door, which a hatch, which seems to lead to the cellar, and you see that there is light coming from like the pits. You can see that there's light inside.
Okay, I'm gonna quietly run back and gesture to the party members. Everyone, come with me. Come on. I don't want the light in the hatch to know that we're coming. But down the hatch we go.
For those of us without dark vision, I mentally tell them that Rhodey is motioning for us.
I hold their hands. I grab everybody's hands.
Because
I'm a sweetheart.
How many hands have you got?
I've got two hands, but I think that the only two without dark vision are Hawkins and Peleus.
Really? The bird's got the worst vision?
Yeah.
Wow. We should get him some specs.
Spell attack modifier does indeed include your proficiency.
Incredible.
Okay. I told you. So
you're all going to the cellar?
Yeah.
Okay.
I kicked down the hatch.
The hatch was already open.
I
just
kick
falls
it.
In.
Oh. I close it and then I kick it in.
What happened to stealth, damn it?
So it's not stealthy. Okay, so as you enter, you see...
Well, is there anything to be gained by listening?
It's a bit late for that.
Yeah.
True.
That cat is out of the bag.
You see...
I shoot the cat.
Wow! Savage.
Nice shot. Right between the eyes. Yes.
He wanted to spare all of the corgis, but he shoots the cat.
He's made the right choices in life.
Cats and birds are natural enemies.
Is this a pillar or is it the hatch?
It's a pillar. And to it are tied three people.
Sexy wenches. Sorry.
Sexy wench?
They have a full rounded mouth.
What was that, Teddy?
They can't, like, they have a thing tied around their mouth so they can't speak. They look very distressed.
Well, you would.
How close are we to them?
You are over here.
We just
here.
Met them.
The hatch is over there.
We're here? Okay. Ah. So I can't telepathically communicate with them.
Guys, try not to speak over Ted.
Yeah, so you see this guy, he has just opened the box, which is on the table, and from it you see cloakers sliding, but also something else, which it's much smaller than the cloaker and looks like little squiddies, sort of.
Squiddies? Is this something we've seen before? And I'm forgetting.
A squid.
Oh, just a squid.
Small squid.
Yeah. And they start slithering towards the pillar.
Oh.
Now, and so they all notice you entering.
Guys, there were 10 dudes outside. There were 7 cloakers. There's 3 here. The maths.
I would like to.
Yeah, you see.
I'd like to make a wall of fire around the pillar.
I shout, "Help! The inn is on fire!"
Fucking hell!
Perfect.
They don't say anything, and they just start walking towards you. Initiative.
Do I? Oh, damn it! Really want to make that wall of fire.
I feel like we surprised them. Maybe we should get a surprise round. If you kick a hatch out, you know, that's pretty surprising. It's surprising.
Yeah, but you didn't have any intention to attack them.
Okay, that's fair.
Yeah, we didn't really know what was down here. Fair.
Alright, I'll take it.
Right now. So what to do stuff.
Surprise attack. Oh, 2 of them. Shit.
Everyone's raining. Snapplejacks, my initiative is bangerang.
Blaze, you are a gentleman and a prince.
Love you too, baby.
Let's see. Why is it and in broken? The game.
Because he kicked it in.
Ho-ho.
Okay. Turn order. There we go. Right, oh shit, I have to delete everything. Okay. Well, not everything. I think.
No, you've got everything in there. At this point. Click on the cog and figure it out from there.
Yeah.
It looks like you already removed the other bits, so that's good.
So that's all of you? No, Hawkins is twice in. Which one did Hawkins roll?
Hawkins rolled a 20 because he has advantage, and that makes everything a little bit trickier.
Okay.
But it's well worth it.
I'm going to add creatures rolled this. Creatures rolled that. Sort. Okay, so someone critted?
Two of us did. It was me and Odd.
Okay, so you gain an extra round, right? Is that what happens?
That isn't.
Yeah, is
that the case, Universal?
You get a surprise round, I think.
It's the way we've been doing it. Yeah,
it's the way we've done it in Numenera. I don't know if that's how we do it in 5e.
Yeah, I don't know if it's entirely. I'd need to double check, but I think it's fair.
Blood Tide, you can make a ruling either way.
Let's say you gain an extra action.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Delightful. So before us, just so that I can figure out what to do with my spectacular initiative, before us we see 3 villagers. There are 3 people that are tied to this column, and out of this box are slithering a number of beasts.
Yeah, let me just put those down.
Yeah, if you could give me some beasts to beat up.
the smaller because they are smaller.
Oh, cute little squid guys. Oh my gosh. This is way cuter than dire corgis, guys.
Have some unique opinions on cute.
I'm going to shout to the this villager, "What are you doing?" And then, without waiting for any response whatsoever,
you're gonna punch him in the face.
No, I'm gonna hit him with a guiding bolt, which is the meanest thing I can do in the whole game.
Jesus.
Ooh.
Oh, that is the worst. Hits. That is the worst damage roll possible, though. That's 4d6, and I got 2 ones.
He falls to the ground.
Suck it up, jerk. Dies. Bite me.
I think.
That's what you get.
Don't say bite me.
Yeah,
the cloak.
That's true. Well, if he's dead, then...
Yeah, bite him.
Oh, man, that sucks, because the nicest thing about Guiding Bolt is that it gives next attack rolls advantage. Anyway, I flip him off.
Rockstar.
Okay, so that's one of your actions.
Mm-hmm. Up next, I'm going to come up to this person. Well, I'm going to come up over here and pull the rag out of one of the victim's faces and say, "Speak!"
Could you reach it? Because you're a dwarf.
I can use Step of Wind to jump.
She just shouts at you, "Help! Help these maniacs! I don't know what they're trying to do."
Help the maniacs?
Got it.
No, help us!
Oh! Thanks for clarifying.
Okay, I don't know if pulling the rag out from her mouth counts as a full action or a bonus action. That's up to you.
It's a bonus action.
Bonus action? Okay. So with my full action, I'm going to headbutt the person next to me. Right there. Sorry, this takes forever to do. Take this! And this!
She just falls down after the first attack.
Eat shit!
Why is there a card here?
I don't know.
Okay. Is that your turn?
It is my entire turn. It is my turns. Thank you.
Odd.
So, odd also critted, just for the record.
Yeah.
So I do one turn and then another turn.
No, you do. You just get an extra action.
An extra action. Okay. Yeah. So, but after my turn, we still have a full round where everyone's going to do something.
Well, there's it just goes by the word.
Yeah. Yes, that's what I meant. Okay. So in that case, I'm gonna. I had it. I scrolled too far. I'm going to walk and then. God. This is terrible. I can't do it. Okay, so I'm instead going to. Come over here. So, is that what I said? One more. I'm going to come over here, which is in range of the tied up people. And I'm going to telepathically ask them if any of these creatures have any weaknesses we should know about.
There is one. The two are not actually facing them, but the one that is Actually, how would the villager respond to being communicated telepathically?
I mean, they're in the building that had the telepathic communication things. So I don't know. It's your choice how the villager responds.
How does, can someone explain telepathy to me?
So I think something, and then the villager just, can hear it.
They just hear a voice in their head.
They hear a voice in their head, but if they've got rags in their mouth, only one has got their mouth free, right? So they can't necessarily respond.
No, so he just doesn't respond.
Oh, so I guess I misunderstood. I can communicate. I can't.
Can't hear them. They need telepathy to do that.
Okay, that's fine. In that case, I only get one turn's worth of movement, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Throw multiple fireballs. How many fireballs do you have?
I have zero fireballs. I have firebolt.
We need an area of effect while these critters are all together.
Is there some sort of running, dashing thing?
You can spend an action to make your movement again.
Since I have two actions, I'm going to do that.
I have an area of effect, by the way, but it's only for things on the ground. Are those squid
they're
things?
They're all on the ground.
Oh, they're all on the ground. Right, okay. Interesting.
Okay, so I'm going to use one of my actions to move to here.
Oh, boy.
And then I'm going to use my other action to cast as a level 4 spell.
Oh, Jesus.
Color spray.
Oh, okay.
Damn.
So.
Wow.
So okay. That's 6 plus 6. So that's 12 d10 that I'm going to roll.
That's how many hit points you can affect, right? That's a lot
of hit points.
Jesus, math.
Okay. Yeah, that's a lot of math. All of a sudden.
Okay. Let's start from these ones. So that's... This one is...
So it starts with the lowest hit points ones.
Is... Oh no, a blind, no sleep. Blind there. Oh, it starts from with the lowest?
It says creatures are affected in ascending order of current hit points.
Blind. That's math. -45.
I'm also gonna roll for wild magic.
Jesus.
I'm safe.
Okay, that's all the creatures affected. What does blind do? A blinded creature can't see and automatically fails in any required sight. Attack rolls against the creatures have advantage, and the creature's attack rolls have disadvantage. Okay.
Not bad.
I like it. Do you have any more movement?
I went here and then there, so I have 5 feet. So I could disengage to here.
You can't disengaging is a full movement action.
It's a full movement. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So you can move five feet away and then provoke an attack of opportunity from both people or critters in your field.
Because I'm sort of thinking about your... What's your hit situation?
All right, so I have provoked an attack of opportunity.
From
or two. This villager actually is already dead.
Let's say from one of them. Yeah, no,
this guy's dead. I already killed him, but this one might be able to.
Yeah. So he's gonna attack you with his tail. There. Tail attack.
My AC is 13.
Okay, does not hit.
Yeah.
And that's your turn.
Yep.
Universal.
Okay. Let's see. I am going to cast a spell. And a spell I haven't used before called Spiked Growth. Great damage. But essentially it creates that radius of pain for anyone moving within it. So I fire an arrow into the ground and I think it's going to be like 20 feet around a square. So if I fire it this sort of range? Right.
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So that's 20 feet in every direction there.
Is that...
So it's like a full, okay. I think it's a full 20 feet. 20 foot radius, that would be correct. Would it? I don't know.
No, radius is...
Oh, wait,
it's like this. So it's like twice as big.
Shit.
It'll hit me and also the victims, like the people on the...
Yeah, but what if you aim it off the...
Yeah.
In that case, does it deal damage immediately?
No, it only deals damage when someone moves through
it.
So,
I'm not the only one anymore.
There.
Yeah. Wait. So.
And then, because it's bigger, let's assume it goes out this way. Because I don't want to, you know, stop anyone else from moving through it.
Like it goes over here, okay. So that's
okay. So that's my first attack, and then with my second attack,
spells take up an entire action, so that you cannot. Oh, right. Even though you have an extra attack, that only works if you take the attack action. So it's not fair that enough. You have two actions; it's that you can attack twice in one action.
If I attack, got it. Okay. And I guess I won't move anywhere. I'm happy enough.
Okay. The creatures. Right. So, first of all.
Now, did the creatures get a 35 on their initiative?
No, they had a 19. They just jumped.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So the cloakers.
That would have been 38.
Yeah, it does that to you sometimes as well. It just adds.
I mean, it doubles, but it doesn't. Like, it doesn't.
It was definitely 19 because someone got a 20, and I was after creatures.
Oh, okay, very good. Never mind.
I remember.
This is gonna take 6 damage.
I don't know why it was.
And it's there. Going to wrap itself around one of the villagers.
Oh, shit.
This one's going to take 3 damage, and it's going to wrap itself around this. 1, 2. Whoops. Whoops. No. Be smaller. It's gonna take also 10 damage. Yeah, 6 damage. Wrap itself around this villager. Wait, is that? Yeah, that should be okay.
Maybe I should have cast that around the villagers because it's not like they're going anywhere.
And now, these three, they're just gonna like move. How long are they blinded for?
One round. So,
okay.
Round, so they'll just be fine.
They're gonna move over there, and they're gonna take each 6 damage. And what you see is from the lady villager who Blaze killed. You see her warm hat and a scarf suddenly start to move. The scarf unwraps itself from her neck, and the hat sort of like stretches itself like off of it and jumps, and eyes open up on it, and you see that scarf and the hat are actually a cloaker and this weird little thing.
Oh man, I killed 2 people for no reason.
And the same happens for this guy.
Well, I stand by my statement to eat shit.
3 damage to both of those.
They don't move. They just like.
Well, they moved into the.
Sure.
Into the world.
I am going to get my value out of this.
I think that is everything. Yeah. Yeah, next. Thief.
Hello. Okay, so we reckon that the 3, or the, not the 3, the people are being controlled, right?
Mm-hmm.
And so I shouldn't go over and just attack them.
Ideally, we want to find the cloakers on them and
do it.
What? Yeah, you notice that the they're all the, like, this villager is also wearing a scarf and a hat.
Because I'm wondering if we get the scarf and the hat off, maybe they will help us because we need more hands on deck.
Now it is worth noting that they obviously suck real bad. Because I killed him with like 6 points of damage.
On the other hand, we could just not worry about the lives of the villagers and get rid of these things much more easily.
These are potential fans, though.
That is true. I think that the ones that are on the pillar, we should worry about. These other guys, they can eat shit.
I was going to just torch all of them. I'm not going to lie.
Okay, I'm going to move over here and attack this one that's between Roti and myself. If I can. Where's my thingy? I assume that hits. So I'll do that as well.
Yeah. Okay. Sure. It takes 19 damage.
You're so sneaky.
Did you see that attack?
No, because you were sneaky.
Thank you.
Sneakiest.
Sneakiest.
Really bad roll, though. Really bad roll.
Everything?
Cool. Oh, sorry. Yeah, that's me. I'm just not much of a... Okay.
If you want, you can take a bonus action to disengage. I will
get a bonus.
Yeah, you do get it. You, as part of your cunning actions class feature.
Oh, that's true. Yeah,
sorry, okay. I play as a rogue, and I don't need to dictate how to play. Just I know the rogue playbook a bit.
Yeah, let's do. And how, like, I can move the rest of my movement, or just a certain distance, or 5 feet, or whatever.
You can disengage, and that's a 5-foot movement, and then you still have whatever other movement you want to have.
I think I've only got 5 left anyway. Okay, I'll move sort of back this way then, in case there's an AoE coming.
Yeah, so now they're just gonna eat me, which is dope. I'm down. You've got hit points to spare.
Okay. This villager is going to come up to you and hit you with a stick that it's picked up from the ground.
Aww.
Is it a stinky stick?
I would like to use my reaction to impose disadvantage on the villager's stick using my warding flare feature on his stick.
Oh, sorry.
Going to impose disadvantage on him, sure. What's your AC? Alright, never mind, doesn't hit.
17.
Does not hit.
I imagine I'm going to catch a couple of attacks, so figured I'd let you know anyway.
Friendly attack. Friendly fire. Not friendly attack? What?
I mean, if history is to tell.
Mm-hmm. So, do we really want to save these people?
Yeah!
I want to save the people around the column, right? Like, those people have not yet been tainted or whatever. The guys that are currently getting ate up by the cloakers, who's to say whether they will be able to recover or not?
But right? I think we got to give them a chance.
If you aim a 20-foot, you can hit here and get these.
I could. I'm debating whether or not to surround this sort of area with a wall of fire that's pointed inwards.
That will still hit.
That's gonna hurt everyone, including Blaze.
Yeah. Do walls point a certain direction? Also,
you can make them into a radius ring instead of a 60-foot wall, and you can point the heat of the flame in or out,
and shake it all about.
So, if I were to not getting the.
Do I need the point? You do the stokey cokey.
If I center it here, I can literally torch everything. Or we can try to be good guys and prolong the encounter by trying to
save the ceiling people. Is made out of wood.
Great, even better.
We're good guys. This is the primary problem you're facing in the game, is that we are definitely very good guys.
Well, I am true neutral, and that is the dilemma.
I'm an extremely good guy, and I'm also the dude that would get hit, and my preference, and it's not an order, my preference is that I not get my ass kicked repeatedly by you.
Okay. Fine. Then instead of doing that, I will cast Fairy Fire.
I love Fairy Fire.
That should, I think, do you have to make a reflex save, all of these people?
Yeah, they've got to make a dexterity save, and then this really helps Scoo out a ton to do
so
that.
So this is centered on here. It's a 20-foot cube. Anyone within 20 feet, I guess, of that point has to make a reflex save. If they fail, they are surrounded in bright red flame, and that gives all of their attackers advantage.
Okay, so all attackers on me now get advantage.
I'm going to bend luck for Blaze there.
Oh, well, thank you.
You also need to roll, by the way, Odd.
I thought you centered it like over here.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a 20-foot cube, not a 20-foot radius. Got it. Yeah, so you don't have to.
Okay, so but not here's bad. My bending luck. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's cool, baby. You did your best.
Do you have to do wild magic?
No.
Okay.
Just when I cast a spell of level 1 or higher.
Oh, Blaze, I'm going to give you my use of inspiration.
Oh, thank you. Let's fucking roll this
bitch
again. There we go. All right.
Does this one get affected as well?
No, it's too far away.
I thought it was 20.
It's pretty much everyone in this center.
It's 20, but it's a 20-foot cube rather than a sphere.
Okay. So Blaze isn't affected?
I have mercifully been saved by my friend Peleus.
Okay, that's the cloakers and the squiddies not get affected.
And I will go stand in the corner next to these barrels, presumably full of ale and mope.
And gasoline.
About how goody two shoes this party is.
I wouldn't say we're goody two shoes. We're just not murderers.
Well, we...
What?
Eli, what are you eating? Tell me.
It's a
cookie.
Is it good? What kind of cookie?
What?
Give me the cookie deets.
It has chocolate chips and that is everything.
Yep. I'm jealous.
You don't have your special American, all kinds of weird cookies.
Rather than murder, I'd like to think of it as a targeted drone strike.
That's awful!
Mm-hmm.
Rosie?
It's ooh, it's my turn. Okay. I'm going to just batter this cloaker. Hang on one second. I'm going to batter this cloaker to within an inch of its fucking life. I'm going to draw my short sword, which I have a short sword because I'm a dwarf and I'm short. I'm going to attack it twice. I'm going to tell it to eat my shit.
Okay, first one hits.
Do you have any on hand?
And you slice one of its wings off.
Okay. I also will use a key point to do a flurry of blows. And by that, I get to do two unarmed attacks.
First one hits, it dies.
Yeah, eat my shit. I think that's Rhodey's catchphrase. That's his kind of perspective on the world is like, let's do the damn thing, and anybody who isn't with me eats shit.
Is that your turn?
That is my turn.
All right. I am going to cast Mirror Image. I'm going to remember to roll for Wild Magic. I am safe from wild magic. I've got three duplicates of myself, and as a bonus action, I'm going to expend...
That's a tree.
as a bonus action, I'm going to expend one level 3 spell slot to regain 3 sorcery points. Ooh. And that is everything I'm going to do.
I like the fungibility of a sorcerer. Like, that's... The ability to exchange sorcery points for spell slots and vice versa is like, that's a really interesting mechanic, and it's one that we haven't seen yet, really.
Yeah.
In our game.
Yeah, it's really cool, and the wild magic stuff works good. Works good. Does good grammars.
What I really want most is for him to do wild magic and then summon 10 flumps. Because that's one of the things that can happen with wild magic. And I don't know why.
Do we get to keep them?
No, they disappear after D6 rounds or something along those lines. But I love the idea of flumps.
They're so nice.
What the hell is a flump? But I love it.
I have, actually, because I have I have been reading the entire monster manual for the past 2 weeks. I've actually read it. They siphon psionic energy, only how much they need to survive and not enough to damage psionic beings. Because they siphon the psionic energy, they actually on like evil psionic beings, and when they find someone like an adventurer, just tell him like any weaknesses that they know.
Okay, so who is in most trouble here at the minute? I feel like Oddward, your character is just like shouldn't be in the mix, so I might target this dude. That seems more sensible.
That's fine, and if it seems like it's gonna hit me, then it might hit one of my duplicates.
Right. You should go for one of the ones with the red dot.
Yeah, that's for the other thing, because Blee is very, very busy.
Are they on people? Because the people will take damage, don't forget. So we have to remove them before we hit them.
Okay. Okay. Tell you what, I will assist you in removing the thing from this dude. And yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I thought they were called flumps, like PS at the end. And flumps are a type of marshmallow you can get over here.
It's true.
Really quite nice ones.
They also siphon psionic.
They do.
What do you rip off?
I'm trying to get rid of
his clothes. He said he wanted to get naked.
Naked.
I'm not trying
to. The hat or the scarf?
The scarf?
Okay, it is ripped off.
Does it make a noise?
Yeah. Do I have to roll anything for that, or is it just easy enough? Do I have to roll for that? Sorry, to take the I was going to say the flump off him, but the clicker off him.
Roll.
I didn't roll.
You have to roll strength. Hello.
What's up?
Hey, baby.
He's giving me that. That red, your connection to the server has been...
Me? Or just anyone?
No, that's Ted. Ted has occasional problems connecting to Discord, and that might be problems from like the actual ISP, or more likely, Ted is on a Wi-Fi connection, because Wi-Fi drops out in a way that really contrasts and fucks up VoIP. So it might be the case that he would be best served by doing an Ethernet connection rather than a Wi-Fi, but we're all doing our best here. We're all riding our own horses.
We got horses?
Well, some of us have elephants.
That's true.
I think we were talking about the elephant in the room.
Mr. Medium Poops is a horse.
Mr. Small Hello? Poops is a squirrel. Hey, Eli, we're back.
I thought Mr. Medium Poops spoke through
okay.
spoke to ghosts through his stool.
What?
Cloaker is ripped off.
Cool. Could I attack it or in the same turn, or is that just it?
Yeah, you can attack.
Okay.
Your extra attack.
Correct. Okay. Short sword. Slash slashy.
Hits.
Okay.
It's not.
Do I see a change in the dude?
Actually, he seems to sort of. He seems to be startled by you taking it off, but he still has like an he still seems to have like an angry face on him.
Oh, right. The hat, right? Okay, I think that's all I can do.
Okay. Creatures. The three guys on the pillar are now unconscious, and the squiddies, which are no longer blind, are starting to crawl up them.
If they're in my zone, they take some more damage?
But it's like they crawl on them, so it's not on the floor.
Oh, I'm just thinking of this one, I suppose.
Don't let them get in his zone.
Yeah, sure, he'll walk over there and then take three points.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. Now, this one is going to start crawling up you, Blaze.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
There's
not a long way to go because I'm pretty short.
Yeah, okay. Well, that actually matters. Thanks for noticing, mentioning.
Uh-huh. Sure.
This one is going to jump at you, Universal.
Yeah.
Who is 40 foot tall, don't forget.
Mm-hmm.
That actually matters.
Let's see.
See, whenever that thing climbs up onto Blaze's head, I just want to see a kung fu kick.
Okay.
And I see him kick it off his own head.
I'll try it.
Wraps itself around your neck, and you take 9 piercing damage.
Oh dear. Right.
And now, this one is gonna attack you, so you have to roll. What was it? How does mirror image work?
Mirror image works such that you roll a d20, and if it's above, I think, 14 for it, having all
the
different
roll a 6 or higher.
No,
if
it's...
You have, okay.
If you
it
have
depends
one.
Depends on how many players
yeah,
there are.
Because you destroy the duplicates as you attack them, but the deal is, I think, for the first one, where you have all three duplicates, you have to roll 6.
Yeah, it's 6 or higher when there are 3 duplicates. It gets harder as the duplicates are destroyed.
Right. So it's 6 or higher to attempt
you
to fight the duplicate.
Oddwood.
No. I roll the d20.
You guys
figured
out. To
see if it hits me.
Yeah.
So you're attacking me, so I'm going to...
So basically, it's more likely he will roll higher than a 6 to begin with, because there's more mirror images, and it gets harder as there's
so
less
it,
of them.
It hits one of my mirror images.
Yeah. If it hits,
yeah.
Try and fight it.
My duplicate's AC is 13.
It's the same as yours. Okay, it does hit it. This duplicate disappears and it just sort of stumbles confused. Now this one.
One more 3 of damage.
Yeah, sure.
I can just tell you hit me already for that.
This one is also going to take three damage. And it's going to try and climb up. Roll another d20.
Okie dokie. That also hits a duplicate.
Okay, so it's this one disappears and just sort of jumps over here. I think that's it for all. Actually, this one latched on it's on you this turn, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, that's all of them.
Okay.
Alright, do I help you guys out or go for a hit on one of the two by Oddwood? Because bearing in mind, if I hit one that's on you, you're going to take damage. I'm not very strong in terms of trying to pull it off you.
Yeah.
Or pull you off it.
Yeah, I think at this point, Oddward could use the support.
So I think, and what's your health situation, Blaze? You all right? Like half, more than half?
I'm a little bit less than half, but it's still 25 points. I'm pretty healthy still.
In that case, I'm going to move up here. No, I'm not. I'm going to change tool. And then I'm going to move up here. I'm going to attack this little squiddy thing with my rapier. Pow!
The squiddy thing, okay. It bloops.
Oh man, I didn't get to do my sneak attack. Can I carry that over to the next guy?
No.
Damn. Okay, then I'm going to just take a step this way. And that will be me.
Okay. This villager is going to punch Blaze again.
Stop that.
He likes that, you know.
Enough!
That means more. Yeah, he's really kinky.
Yeah, I didn't say my safe word. Yeah, that's true. Banana.
Banana is also not his safe word. He's just hungry.
Just a terrible safe
next
word.
Friendly fire.
What to do?
Live, maybe Pelias. Not that. Damn you, live.
Well, I'm now faced with my same moral conundrum. Do I kill everyone or
no?
Not?
Stop killing everyone. Jeez.
But I keep hearing the dulcet tones of what sounds like Blaze in my head.
Do it.
You see, it's hard to resist.
Kill them all.
Also, that's your safe word. That's
you also hear my me telepathically. Oh wait, no, you're out of range. So you can't hear me saying, "Don't do it! Don't do it! Don't do it!" But that's what I'm thinking.
Do it. They're all trash cans waiting to be lit.
It's not him talking. It's the squid.
Is anyone getting hit really?
We really want to defend these folks tied to the pillar here. If you need to take out a couple of our heroes to do it, it's fine. But the folks on the pillars are really, they're a little bit squishy. They're really extremely squishy.
How strong are you?
There's not really not very strong. There's not really anything I can do for them. Is that a cloaker on Odd, I see?
On Hawkins.
It's next to him.
It's in front of Odd or on Hawkins, yeah.
I'm going to strafe to the left.
Strafe. Whoa, how did he do that? He was facing one way but moving another. He just like crab walked across the room like...
He was holding me.
Imagine he went, whoop, 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 whoop.
That's exactly right. And I'm going to fire a guiding bolt at this cloaker that's in front of my good friend Odd. Pow!
Wham! It just keeps going, I reckon. I think it just pushes him all the way over to the barrels.
Does a 21 hit the cloaker?
Yeah. Of course it does.
Well, it takes 16 radiant damage, and the next person who attacks it has advantage.
Yeah, nice.
It's still alive then.
Yeah, it's still alive.
Okay.
And that is my turn. My goody two shoes turn.
You've done poorly.
Rody, you have a squiddy thing crawling up your leg.
Rody, I'm going to telepathically ask you to at least move a step back.
Okay, can do.
You can just like shout out.
But this is more fun.
It's way cooler. It is way cooler to be told that telepathically. There is a voice in my head commanding me to move this way, and so I'm going to do that and take the squid with me. I'm going to try and yank it off my face.
Okay, roll a unskilled strength.
Okie dokie. Get off.
Nope.
All right, I'm gonna... So the way we've been playing it is that this unskilled strength check is an attack that is a portion of the attack action. Because I have extra attack, can I make another attempt to rip that bad boy off? Okay. Get off!
Whoa!
I mean, 420
through the hatch.
420, Blaze Masterson.
It's fucking spinning around.
It took every time it moved through one of those squares. It took damage.
Listen to this guy. actually,
you threw it to the other end of the booth.
Awesome.
He's covered in the flappy dude and he's counting every time. Peeking out between the cloaker's wings. Ah, there's another one.
Three damage.
You there. You look more hurt now.
Okay, is that your turn?
I think... Well, let me see. I can take... Okay, so this is going to be up to you. If those count as an attack action, I can use martial arts to do a bonus action where I punch the cloaker that is on Hawkins.
Yeah.
Okay.
Punch it?
Yeah. Sure. Okay. That's what I love best in the world. Ooh, pretty.
You hit...
Hawkins, you're going to have to eat a little bit of shit.
Take 5 damage.
Yeah, sorry, Hawkins.
Okay. That's okay. Well, it's not great, but I can live with it. Just about.
And that truly is the end of my actions.
Okay.
All right. So, as my bonus action... I'm going to expend the 6 sorcery points that I have available to create a level 4 spell slot so that, for my action, I can cast Confusion, which affects all these folks. I'm assuming it doesn't affect the villagers because they're asleep?
Sure. Yeah, they're asleep.
So, I... They need to all make a wisdom saving throw.
Oh, wowie zowie.
Okay. Wisdom is this. Okay. What does it do?
So on their turn, they have to roll a d10, and based on the effects of that roll, it determines what they do. It'll either be nothing, or run away, or attack someone randomly, or act normally.
How long does the fairy fire last for, by the way?
Ah, an excellent question.
Concentration basically lasts up until you cannot
up
concentrate.
To 1 minute. It's concentration up to 1 minute.
Okay. How many turns has it been? Whatever. We'll see that it lasts.
10 turns is really an impossibly long amount of time. 10 turns is almost forever.
Okay. So the cloakers get confused. Is that everything?
That is every... I'm gonna move. I will leave it up to you to determine if I'm this one, the one, this
you're
one.
This one. You're the one.
Okay,
you.
Fine.
I remember.
So I'm gonna move. Oh wait, here. I'm gonna move over to here, and that will.
Roll a d20. See if it hits your.
So this hits yes. My duplicate.
Okay. Let's see if it hits. It does not. You get to keep your duplicate. And that's Ed Hawkins.
Neat. Right. I don't suppose this thing came off my face when Blaze hit it. Okay, I am going to try and rip it off. So, let's see. Strength.
Yeah. God, you guys are so good at stupid rolling. It comes off.
Whenever it's pointless, we will defeat it every time.
Okay, and as it gets ripped off my face, I'm going to ply the short sword to its horrible face. Ooh! Okay. It's not that great, but... It was a good roll.
8 points of damage.
Yes.
Okay.
Could I take a careful step here just to sort of... No, wait, no. No, that's okay.
Okay. That's it?
Yep.
Okay. Right, I'm gonna roll some dice.
Is this one confused?
No. I don't think so. What did it? Right, nothing happens. Let's start with the ones that aren't confused. This one is gonna tail attack Universal. Tail attack. I'm guessing 21 hits you.
No, just missed.
You take 5 bludgeoning damage.
Ow!
A bit. This one is gonna move up to Teeth. It's gonna tail attack you. You also take 5 bludgeoning damage. Okay, school.
Wait, did it beat me at my AC?
Yeah, it's a 22.
All right, okay.
Okay.
Might need it.
Right. So the let's see what the how well I can. Okay, let's see. If you can't take reactions, D10. Okay, slash roll. D10. That. Okay, so that's 2. What does 2 do?
The two and the 3 don't take any actions. And the 7 attacks a random thing within reach.
Attacks a random thing within. Let's see, it's this one. It's gonna peel itself off the villager. Within range. Guess it will attack the villager. This guy. And right, it's going to tail attack it. And hits, villager falls to the ground, and off of it come off to a dark mantle. I mean, you didn't hear that, and a cloaker.
An additional cloaker?
Oh, whoops.
It sounded like something else.
Yeah, the squiddy thing. Meanwhile, the squiddy things which are on the squiddy things which are on the villagers on the pillar have managed to get onto their heads. They've wrapped themselves on their heads, and now the villagers wake up, and that's it for now. Yeah.
I wake up refreshed and completely fine.
How did Teef get there? Or is it?
Okay,
that's fine. Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to attack the one in front of me. Like that. Oh, boy. It's not good, is it?
No.
Well, that's it then.
Okay, friendly fire.
Wait, I can disengage, I think.
You can.
Let's do that and take a step.
It's a bonus action, and then run away. Yes,
yeah, I'm gonna like get over here somewhere. Okay, now I'm done.
Bravely ran away. Away.
Okay. Friendly fire.
I'm here.
Okay.
Blaze, I'm going to need you to ramp up the
fireball them all.
Oh, whoops. I forgot. This squiddy guy is going to move up to here. That's it.
Yeah, I think he went through that zone there.
No, he did not.
Hey, there are three unattached monsters there, aren't there?
There are.
Yeah.
These guys.
Like
these
here, guys. Yeah.
There's also one unattached here. Or
On the pillar?
Yeah.
No, they're all attached.
I thought one of them disengaged.
So he's going to like move over there.
How many rounds has it been that I haven't lobbed a fireball and killed or burned an innocent bystander?
Three rounds.
We are very impressed with you. You're doing great. Just hang on.
I don't know if I can do
the very funny thing.
I feel like I should have some sort of counter.
It has been 0 days since Friendly Fire friendly fired.
No, I mean rounds since start of combat. It's a little more severe than that. Okay. Is it fine if we leave one? I think it's fine if we leave one.
That is your call.
Hawkins is standing guard.
Okay. I would like to cast Fireball centered on this square.
That would affect who?
That would affect everyone except one of the creatures attached to the central pillar and the dark mantle that's south of the pillar.
Okay.
I will just strafe slightly to the left. And go ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-ka-boom!
Okay, so we all have to make a DC 14.
Pretty sure this one dies, this one dies. Pretty sure. Oh, actually, it might survive. Uh, this one dies.
Is that 13 damage? Do I take 13 damage?
Yep.
Roti falls.
As a bonus action,
it's fine.
I would like to cast Mass Healing Word on everyone.
Because I'm a 2.
Which will bring up everyone's hit points by 5.
Wow. Roti wakes up devastated.
If only I hadn't told him to burn everything.
No, that was Trash Canosaurus Rex. It's not me.
Absolutely.
No, you sounded like
it. Trash Canosaurus Rex is a little sexier.
You don't play yourself down.
Oh, especially when angry.
Okay. Turn and shoot friendly fire.
Do you really?
I'm thinking about it.
I will impose disadvantage on you.
We've got bigger problems than friendly fire.
Do we, though?
Do we?
Not this time. Yeah, I mean, this time, yes, we do.
I feel like he's done more damage to me than
I think that villager just dies.
Yeah, so, yeah, I'm sure.
But a dump. Another one bites the dust.
So there's one villager remaining.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now we can all concentrate our efforts. Isn't that glorious?
Well done. Well done.
Is that your turn?
Not medium. Well done.
That trash fire within me is starting to feel luxurious.
Let's see. Okay, who's next? Oh, yes.
Roti.
Yeah. Poppin'. Okay, so hang on. How did the fireball affect this Joker right here?
Did it?
Which joke?
Oh. Was it not supposed to? Was it not
I would like to remind the GM that the central pillar and the roof above us are made of wood, as well as the desk and the barrels on the right side of the room.
Fuck. Well, these barrels are out of range.
So basically, the roof is on fire.
The roof?
Did you say the roof?
The ceiling.
The roof is on fire.
Oh no, good correction. It is. I didn't. Like, it wasn't the joke, but what? More accurate.
Okay, has the guy in front of me eaten shit yet? This is the question.
Well, he was on you a minute ago.
Do you want to examine to see if they're
if they have feces from their mouth.
Yeah.
What's your perception like?
It will take, you use your action to
do a shit or a perception check. Yeah. I'm going to beat this dude into unconsciousness with my extremely hot fists.
Name of your sex type.
Buy him a drink first.
That hits.
Okay. Is he alive?
He is alive.
Okay, I'm gonna beat him
again.
And now
he's pissed. He's pissed at you.
He is dead.
Okay. With this, I'm going to use the rest of my movement, and my martial arts allows me to do another unarmed attack. What I'm hoping, dear GM, is that it allows me to use an unarmed attack to rip the beast off of this one remaining villager.
The one on its face or the one around its neck?
Can we have someone fucking live through this? Please.
You're using a bonus action to do?
It is my martial arts that allows me to do an unarmed attack. So when unarmed, I'm using an unarmed attack to do that.
I'm going to rule that that does not, you have to use
fair enough attack. I'm going to go ahead and punch the beast. No, I'm not. That's terrible.
There's a, well, there's one over here.
Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and yeah, I will give him a little punch right to his grilled piece.
Okay.
I remind that squid to eat some shit.
Well, the squid probably does as a bottom feeder, I imagine.
Biodiversity.
A real bottom feeder.
Stop it.
All right, so that's it? Okay.
I am done, yes.
As a bonus action, I will expend one level 2 spell slot to gain 2 sorcery points. And then, as my action, I am going to aim at this dude and cast a simple firebolt.
It misses.
It's a cantrip, so no wild magic.
Boo.
It's a 1. I think I could make it hit Hawkins.
Oh no.
But I'm just gonna make it set the ceiling on fire over here.
On extra fire.
And fall and hit Hawkins.
Don't give me ideas. Okay, is that everything?
That is everything.
Okay, Hawkins. Would you like to move away from the burning ceiling?
Why not? Why not indeed? Let's see. So yeah, I'm going to move back to here. Gives me attack opportunity. That guy takes, yeah.
Actually, no. Because, no.
Okay. Right. Well, I am going to shoot at him anyway. My bow. I use my bow. And with my bow, I do this.
It hits. It dies.
Cool. And I will, with my second attack, go for... Well, that guy's on fire, so... Hey.
Well, not really.
Oh, he's not. Oh, the fire.
Yeah, because it's the ceiling's on fire. He's on the... yeah.
Okay, well, I'll go for this guy then. And
miss.
I'm gonna
bend
luck.
Well, I don't think it matters in that case because I rolled a 1.
Oh, you got a 1. Misses.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, you just miss. I mean, what can happen?
Probably
can't really hit anything.
Hits a wall. I lose the arrow.
You actually...
I have to replace that arrow.
With what?
Another arrow.
Let's say you hit the ceiling and it falls. The ceiling, it falls over here.
Okay.
That's your turn?
Yeah, I think that's it.
Okay. This... Oh yeah, I need to roll 1d10. What? No. / roll 1d10. An 8. What happens on an 8?
Dog just goes mental on an 8.
On an 8, the creature uses an action to make a melee attack against a randomly determined creature. If there is no creature, the creature does nothing. Okay, so it does nothing. It just stands there. Meanwhile, this guy, the villager here, just stays as it is. And this little guy is going to jump on Blaze. And that's it.
Teeth.
Yeah.
Yo. I'm gonna run over here. Hang on. Is that that's a person under there?
Or yeah.
Is that? Is there a person on this one?
Nope. Oh, actually, I forgot. This cloak would also for confusion. Let's see what happens. A 6. I don't think that does anything. Yeah, it doesn't take it. It doesn't do anything.
I realize that we never asked what the name of this town is. Maybe it's better that way.
I don't think it's going to exist after we leave.
Phandalin. I don't know if there's much I can do. Without
you can always disengage.
But I'm not engaged. Okay, I'm gonna run over.
You can shoot that cloak over there.
Do you have any ranged weapons?
I think you should.
Like a crossbow?
I'm gonna run over
as
here.
As a tiefling, you can run into fire and not give a shit.
It's not. I mean, it won't. If you just like duck your head. Actually,
I'm quite low on health, though. That's the concern.
Yeah, the ceiling is slowly falling down.
Is there anything on that desk that we need or should get?
There's the box and the candle.
Yeah.
Yes. Get it.
I mean, the the box burning, I don't mind.
This is Trash Canosaurus Rex.
But he really wants that candle.
Friendly, go get it.
What I think a couple of rounds back, one of the cloakers died like right in front of me, so I'm going to grab its tooth while I'm about it with my pliers. Because like, I might miss an opportunity to do that again.
With your pliers, okay.
Yeah, it was somewhere around here, like in front of me, I think, roughly. Yeah. And I've got a short bow, which I suppose I could try and take a shot with. I'm not very good with it.
It's all worth it.
Let's give it a shot. Wow!
Not all very right. Good, he says.
You kill it. Didn't put in a crit. What's it? Oh, you yeah, it wasn't a crit. Okay, dice.
No. I've just got a lot of decks.
Huh.
Sorry. Oh dear, I'm such a child.
It's not your turn. Friendly fire.
I think I heard the voice of my god telling me to go grab a candle from a burning table. Is that correct?
I thought that there was something else on the table. There was a box, there was a candle, and then there was something else. Is this correct, Ted?
No.
Oh.
Just a box and a candle.
Just eat shit, then.
Where's he going to find shit at this time of night?
I'm sorry. Save the villager.
Oh, save the villager.
Where's this come out?
Yeah, sorry, I fucked that one up.
Save the cheerleader, save the world.
Really? Does the villager appear to be...
It's awake, and it's starting to try and get out of its rope, although I doubt it will succeed.
But has it been hurt at all?
No, because I'm pretty sure it would have died.
Aha. What to do? Oh, I have an idea. Wonder if that works. I would like to cast Sanctuary on the villager.
What's a sanctuary do?
Yo, that's so dope. That is an actual wise move.
You ward a creature within range against attack. Until the spell ends, any creature who targets the warded creature with an attack or harmful spell must first make a wisdom saving throw. On a failed save, the creature must choose a new target or lose the attack or spell.
So I think that looking at this spell and seeing that it requires a small silver mirror to cast, I assume you reach over and grab one off of my hat.
I mean, nice. Obviously.
Yes, of course.
I think I just grab your entire hat with one hand.
From one of the mirror images.
And then I point the hat at the villager and fire a beam of holy light at him, which doesn't hurt him, surprisingly.
How many times have you pointed a hat at someone?
You know, I have a query with this.
If you've got one of the hats, does that now render the other mirror illusion useless? Because it's obvious they're different.
No, the illusion always looks like me.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, hang on. So, if he took your hat, then the creatures would know which one.
Oh, jeez. Okay, so that was a bonus action. I guess everyone else, all the other bad things are pretty wrecked.
Fireball.
All of your actions are bonus actions. They all bonus.
Hey, that's not true. You have survived every encounter we've been in together.
Somehow, yes, somehow.
Because Skoo has fire resistance, yes. And
have you seen my health right now?
I'm hearing a lot of...
A heal as well.
I would like to, since that was my bonus action, begin a performance.
You can move and try and help. Please take the...
Would that be like aid another? Is that a thing?
It's an action. You just like the same as remove it. You were trying to remove it from him.
Hmm. Oh, I see. So Blaze has a thing on him.
Get that squid off your friend's face.
Is there any way that I can target the squid?
Aim at it.
It will hurt him too.
Aim at the face.
The first explanation of all this, that he is actually just praying to Blaze's character. He just doesn't know it.
Yeah, I think rather than help Blaze, because I don't think he really wants my help, I'm going to instead...
You're right.
Start a song singing the praises of Trash Canosaurus Rex. Bam. That's how I spend my turn.
Okay.
How amused is everyone by the song? How entertained? Are they not entertained?
Extremely.
They are mediocrely entertained.
It's a good song, but I mean, what has Trash Canosaurus Rex done for us? I don't like being on fire.
Like I said, you've survived every encounter we've been in together.
Barely.
Yeah.
Sacrifices have to be made.
Let's sacrifice friendly fire. Okay. I'm not mad.
I didn't even hurt anyone this round.
This round.
That's all right. I don't know what you're all complaining about.
I'm proud of you.
It's been one round since friendly fire.
Yeah, fire. The pillar is starting to catch fire now. Also, ceiling collapses a bit.
Okay.
Probably.
All right, I've got a short sword. I'm going to cut this person loose. And then try and drag them away. I'm gonna use my movement action. And I imagine that for two people, it would be halved. And I'm just gonna drag them away from the fire.
You're dragging the person away?
Yeah, the person who also has the stupid.
Can you make a strength and unskilled?
You bet.
Don't forget to move the little thing that was on top of him.
No, you should forget that.
Okay, you succeed.
Thanks.
Oh, whoops. It's a pillar.
The entire building collapses.
Guys, check out how strong I am.
You didn't cut the ropes properly. Instead, you just rip. When you take the person, you rip the entire pillar off. So.
That's what I get for a bad roll.
Is that you?
That is going to be my entire action, I think, is just trying to rescue this one person from this one village that has just been dominated by horrifying creatures.
All right, so as my bonus action, I'm going to expend one level 2 spell slot to gain 2 more sorcery points. And as my action...
Oh my god, that shit is so cool. Like, it really is. That is so dope.
Mage hand, and the hand is going to appear right here.
Okay.
What do you do with it?
I'm going for that box.
You're gonna try and take the box.
I'm gonna try and get the box. I can't do it until next turn, but I'm gonna try and get it because it takes one action to command the hand to do something.
One, yeah, sure. Put a hole in the box.
Sorry. Okay. Is that it?
That's me. Yeah.
Okay, Hawkins.
Okay. Anyone who's left who hasn't been shot, getting shot. I guess it's those two by Blaze, yeah?
Well, I mean,
there's a villager, Okay, in that case, can I run and try and whip this thing off Blaze's head?
Yeah, sure. Do a strength thing.
Strength. Oh, snap.
Wow. Yeah.
Could I just into the fire, kick it up into the ceiling?
Yeah, into the fire.
Ah, sure. Yeah, you just kick it into the wreckage and 1d6 fire damage.
What sound does it make?
Wait.
How does it smell when it's cooked?
Delicious. Like calamari.
It makes the sound.
Beautiful.
I take it and after it's been cooked, I roll it up and I roll all the other ones up with it. It's calamari damacy.
Universal.
I'm a bad person.
You've done bad today.
But he did it so well.
That's why I love him.
Is that it for your turn?
I think so, yeah.
You have an extra attack. You can probably shoot it.
Shit, yeah. Yeah, absolutely. As it's cooking, I shall do that. The longbow.
Still alive.
I'd like to think I threw it up into the ceiling and shot it. Blew up, so it's now pinned to the ceiling.
It's amidst the wreckage. Burning wreckage. Okay. So now it's this thing. It's going to take an additional 1d6 fire damage. And it dies. Burns to a crisp.
Burning down the house.
Yeah, okay. Meanwhile, this villager is gonna turn to you, Blaze. He's gonna punch you.
You poor fool!
He does not hit. Thief.
Right, so we don't want to kill this guy, right? We've got to get that thing off him, yeah?
Yep, we're going to try and save one of these dudes, yeah.
Right, I'm not very strong, but I might as well go for it because I've got literally nothing else I can do. That is an unskilled. Oh, I've got a negative to this
it's
as well. It's
under skills.
Oh!
Hey!
With a minus one as well.
Okay, which one are you going for?
Which was the one that controls them? Is it the neck or the head? I can't remember. Or do you want me to figure it out?
I assume the squid is the best thing to go.
Yeah, let's get the squid off.
Okay. Get it off.
If we have to, bit of squid off.
Is that the name of your
action?
Sex.
Sex action.
Sex hey, action. Get the squid off. And then I'm going to disengage. Go this way. Okay.
The villager falls unconscious.
Oh.
Okay. We can use them. So basically,
this thing needs to roll.
The villager just like took a measly swing at Blaze and then fell over.
Okay, cool. The one, I don't think they do anything.
Yeah, one is do nothing.
Okay.
Sorry. One is, it uses all its movement to move in a random direction.
No.
Okay.
Fuck.
No, that's the cloaker.
There's so many landmines. Oh, okay, it's not the villager. Check.
Okay.
So
I'm going to roll.
This could work really well. You roll a d8 and assign a direction to each face.
That's four, so let's see. One, two, three, four. Okay.
Southeast.
Let's see.
You have to switch out of the ruler tool set.
Yeah, I'm just
Yeah, word
movement,
up.
How much movement they have.
Yeah.
That worked out quite well.
The villager is still unconscious.
Pick him up.
Oh, maybe I will.
Friendly fire.
Friendly, can you I'll yell out as a free action. Friendly, hop up the shaft.
What?
Nope, I'm not touching that.
Whoa.
Oh god.
That's the best offer he's had all week.
You want me to jump onto the central pillar?
No, there's a hatch orange up thing. Here.
Ah.
That where we can escape from, my darling.
Oh, I see. What about this this yonder dark mantle within the flames?
Fuck him.
No, don't do that.
Could you say that in the voice of my god?
Fuck him. No, there's I've got one voice for your god and one voice for a friend. Shit.
Ronnie. Who am I?
Did my best.
I exit the room. Stage left.
Boink.
Check it in.
You press the button for the elevator.
Beam me up, Scotty.
And for, I assume that's your turn. If it's not, that's cool. The roadie is going to grab our village friend and just run up here and chuck him to friendly fire. Get him out of here.
Okay. I'll go.
I've noticed you.
As you get him out, the villager starts waking.
I should don't set him on fire.
I will only set his heart on fire.
You can set him on fire.
I say, hello! Who are you? Why have you done this?
He starts waking up. He's like, eh? Where?
You set the whole village on fire.
What?
You did it.
We saw you in the inn, and we followed you here.
Yeah.
Damn it, man. Don't you know your own powers?
The squid thinks... Oh, it wrapped itself around my neck.
Oh, don't tell me what you do with the missus.
The missus? Where is she?
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
There's good news and there's bad news.
She's in Mississippi, my friend.
Where?
Where all the missuses go.
When did she go?
She left you for the arson you committed.
Arson? Holy shit, that's so rude!
What have I done? And he starts crying.
There.
That's what you get for arson around.
You know, there's someone who can really help you turn your life around.
Trash Canosaurus Rex.
That's right. And I say it in that voice.
Do you want it?
Oh, yeah. That's fucking terrible. Blood Ted, I think the rest of us need to escape this burning building.
Yeah, but are you finished?
There's still Rhodey? A squid and Cloaker.
Rhodey, was that your turn?
No, actually, that was all Trash Canosaurus. Actually, yeah. Yeah, I will say that was my turn, grabbing the villager and chucking him to friendly fire. So, yes, all
right.
My turn.
So for right now, I'm going to use my mirror image as to represent my mage hand. So I'm going to... Okay, so that's 10 feet. I'm going to move here. And my mage hand moves 10 feet to pick up the box. And then... another 20 to get it to here, and I can go up to this far away.
Nice.
And that's me.
Delete that. Okay, box comes with you.
I can only get it to here.
Oh, okay. Fire spreads. ceiling collapses. That's it. Hawkins.
That looks like a really good pizza.
Yes. Let's see. I guess I am backing away, firing at this last dude. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, no, incorrect. You walk into the...
silly thing to do. And with my first attack, it's one of those. And with my next attack...
it dies.
I shoot it again anyway.
Do you want to shoot the cloaker?
The cloaker. Yes, that's what I meant all along.
Okay, he's not dead yet.
Okay.
Okay. Next, this guy needs to roll. God, doubling every single... 64 now. Okay, what does it do in a three?
I believe three is no action.
Okay. Just gonna stay there. Next thief. Okay.
I shoot at
does
it.
Hit. Okay, that does hit. It's still not dead. It's like.
Then I'm gonna move this way.
It's like crawling on the ground.
Sounds a lot like a dog.
Poison drooling from its mouth. Okay. Friendly fire is out. You want to do anything with the villager?
I would like to continue telling him about how following my god and becoming part of my religion can really help him atone for his life sins.
You have fucked up mightily, but I can absolve you.
Oh, I can totally do this. I'm just using thaumaturgy to do this. That's my justification in-game.
He's just, like, speechless. Completely just in awe of what is going on. Just too much information. You can't take it. It's just completely speechless.
The wonder and the power.
Okay. Does everyone just get out?
I mean, when it's my turn, I can move this box into my hands and then get out.
Okay, sure.
Sounds good. We're out. Yay, yay.
The cloak is trapped inside.
Would it be expedient to just light the rest of the houses on fire?
Never speak of this ever again.
Exactly.
As you get out of the house,
can we have a look around to see if there's any like signs, like with names of things, like what is this place called?
You see no signs. You see, and there's a well, and that's it in the middle of the village.
Well done.
Well done, like a steak.
As you exit, you see one of the a villager moving up north quite quickly.
Let's catch them. Can I fly up? I'll do one of those things.
So,
I become very different when I use thaumaturgy, apparently.
What's your speed with flying?
50.
Okay. Oh, you catch up to him. You tackle him. He struggles. He just keeps struggling, and you can recognize the leathery hat and scarf on him.
Ah, okay. Well, I'll fly him back to everyone else. To try and, you know, get a hand with it.
Okay.
It's weird that you're asking for a hand, given that all you have is wings.
But I have hands.
Oh, you do have hands. Oh. Wow, okay, never mind. Sorry, yeah. My bad. Talons.
Very talented. So,
I have a criminal past, and even I'm not that bad.
Yeah. Can we sort of all pitch in to rip the cloakers and dark mantles off these dudes?
I'm just going to punch the shit out of this shit.
Yeah, but we can save two people now.
I think I'd like to take Rhodey aside someday and ask him about his bathroom habits.
Okay, see, you take the
it involves a lot of razors.
and squiddies.
You don't need to punch your shit anymore. You can just dig a hole in the ground.
Okay, and I think we can like throw them into the burning inn or whatever.
Yeah, sure. You manage to deal with them.
Sorry, you cut out there?
The villager is unconscious, this one that you brought back.
Okay.
Okay.
That's fine. Now they can rebuild.
The one villager can rebuild? Yeah, that's true.
They have two. That's a win.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, they can reproduce.
They're both male.
Yep. Totally can reproduce.
I'm going to help him reproduce by giving him 5 points of health back. Wake up.
They can start creating trash bins.
Yes, they can.
Sure, he wakes up. He wakes up.
Okay, hey, my guy, what happened here?
Around, he sees the birdman. He's gone.
I slap him. Wake up. Just enough to really jog his jog him. I'm a big jogger.
What's going on?
Yeah, that's what I want to ask you. We are the heroes who saved some of your time.
Everything is burning.
But that's not our I don't know how to answer that.
Wake up! You have failed your village. Wake up!
What happened? What did they do?
Well,
you were not prepared.
No one was defended. How did this happen? Slap, slap, slap.
How did what happen? I don't know. The last thing I remember is going to sleep.
See, there's your mistake.
Never sleep, and I shake him.
Oh man, this is gonna.
I'll
be
never sleep
trauma.
Again. I promise.
Okay, I think we've helped enough here.
All right, we've solved all these problems.
He looks over at the other villager and he's like, "Rob, what's going on?"
Rob, tell me the answers.
And he,
I slap Rob.
I don't know. We were captured by. We just wanted to have a nice dinner. They took us and they tied us to a pole.
Dinners are bad. Don't sleep. No dinners.
I thought you were a good aligned character.
I really have gone
You've
wrong.
You've really gone off the rails.
Yeah, sorry. I take back both of those. I'm sorry.
Who was it that took you? Was it someone you knew?
Again, it was the Kevishmans.
They sound like a dastardly and original creation.
they were just. This was their house.
Okay. And do you think it burning down speaks to some sort of greater psychological need within you? I'm asking this to you, Teddy.
I just thought of that on the spot. I was like, family names, family, Kevishmans.
That's pretty good, yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll take it.
I really liked the monk's change in alignment.
I feel terrible about it.
So, I think what happened was they were taken over by these crazy... Have people been wearing a lot of scarves and hats recently?
Well, like I said, you saw that they were all wearing like one clothes with the winter.
But were there like a lot of scarves and hats from a particular designer with a sort of nautical theme?
You think about it, and you think that yes, does seem likely that those do remember the scarves and hats looking slightly off.
Yeah. I think that's what happened to you, buddy. So everyone in the town is dead apart from you and Rob here. And yeah, you're welcome.
That'll be 500 gold, please.
Each.
Okay, well, let's take a break here. I need to beverage up.
Okay.
I may have to leave soon.
Yeah, okay, we can probably end soon.
Righty-ho. Are you going to pause the stream, Blaze,
I expect all of you to be in character through the beveraging up process. Yar, I want some wine. That's my Scottish accent.
That is a flawless Scottish accent.
Yeah, isn't that great? All right, cool.
Pretty good, yeah. I mean, how long did you spend in Scotland? I'm assuming it's like 5-10 years, maybe?
Yeah, I've really researched my role.
Mm.
So when you said yar, the common pirate lingo.
Mm-hmm. No, that's the common Scottish lingo, sir.
Pirates, Scottish.
You're thinking of I.
I yar.
I know you yar, but... Scottish
people. I'm back.
Yar.
Yar.
Yar. Right, you didn't do exactly what I expected.
You didn't expect us to burn the town down?
Yeah, that also. missed every single opportunity to examine the creatures. Sure, that's not too important.
Well, we've got a couple of dead bodies here, haven't we?
I've got some teeth.
Well, we threw them into the burning house.
I took some teeth. Everything.
You have a tooth. Yeah, it's like covered in poison.
I do have a magnifying glass.
Yet you didn't use it. That is part of
that's part of my roadie gig. Is I hold the equipment that nobody else has.
I have a box.
Oh yeah, the box is just empty. It's inside its cupboard.
You knew they were just holding them in the box.
Now I am going to. I'm going to. Hint at the fact that the villager that you took was heading north.
Oh yeah, where were you going? Rob? Is it Rob? What's your name?
Hey, Ron.
I was going somewhere.
Where were you going?
Slap him.
I told you the last thing I remember is going to sleep.
So I'm running the game?
But before... Before that.
Before that?
I slap him.
I was just having a nice dinner with my family.
Designing the two towns.
What do they want?
What?
Oh, shit.
Yeah, we're getting some crosstalk. But, yeah. Okay, assuming he was heading somewhere. Maybe there's just like a nest of these things or some sort of other dastardness.
You can try and go in the direction.
Everett's death!
Hello.
Maybe if your sex tape.
What's the name of my sex tape?
Hello.
Something death that you shouted out.
Oh, in another game that I've played in, a first-time player of D&D created the world's most hilarious, at least to us, battle cry. We found out that the enemy had an average-sized member, and so this gentleman yelled, "Average penis, average death!" before giving it.
So when I said name of your sex tape, that was perfect.
Yeah. Oh, can you remind me how we discovered that the enemy had an average size penis?
I don't think we want to know.
You tried to slug him, and I was like, no, you're do that. And you're like, okay. I pulled down his trousers.
No. That does sound like it.
We've got some important bits going on here.
Look, when I play a paladin, I don't mess around.
Do you not? I feel like you do.
Is that what paladins like do?
Look, I created a creed. It was number one, never use your sword on an unworthy foe. Number two, never tell a lie. And number three, never strike first. And so as long as I adhere to those things, paladin, I am.
He's got to be
sure. You're a paladin? I thought you were a cleric.
Oh, no. This is a different game.
Are you saying that he pulled your trousers down first?
No. I do not consider the pulling down of trousers to be aggressive action.
That sounds kind of wrong-ish.
That speaks
also this
much
guy
of your
was,
character.
This or guy lack was, thereof.
This guy was not legit. You know, he was lying. We found out he was a criminal, and I feel like we treated him as well as a paladin can treat a bad person. We didn't kill him.
You seem very, very defensive about this.
No, I'm just explaining, you know, my behavior generally when I play games.
Your play sexual games. Assault of this poor guy.
Hey, man, you're taking pity on
pantsing
like, a murderer
not,
and a smuggler.
Pantsing is not quite sexual assault.
Well, if they're not wearing underwear.
To give you an idea about this guy's reputation, when I pantsed him, everyone around was just like, this guy's causing trouble again.
Got him.
Didn't even give a shit.
Got he.
Oh, dear.
Anyway, back to this game.
Yeah, I think we need to start heading north.
Probably. Oh, how much time do we have?
I don't know.
Yeah,
got,
we'll be
I
going
got
for
time out the ass, baby.
It depends
just
on...
because of all that shit.
I will probably be leaving in the next 20 to 40 minutes.
Okay.
So, if whatever we do, I can just bow out silently at that time, that's fine with me.
I think we'll have to make a party. First, head north.
Yeah.
Sorry, what did you say? You broke
you
up a bit
there.
You
did cut off a wee bit there, yeah.
Let's head north, and I think we'll...
Nope, you cut out again.
Oh, no.
We'll head north, and I think we'll...
Part two.
Oh, right, yes.
With this, yeah.
Oh, cool. Reasonable. Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
So good the offshoot so of the offshoot has a part two now.
Yeah. And I'm thinking of doing an offshoot.
D&Deception.
I like that.
Ah, dear.
Honestly, oh, it's cool. It's cool. I wasn't criticizing. Oh, yeah, cow skin.
And these are rocks.
Is this all the shit that Blaze made people eat?
I jumped directly onto the giraffe.
You come near the big mountain range, and you find a cave leading somewhere unknown.
I believe it's rest time.
Yeah, yeah. I've got like 7 health, so
yeah.
Let's have a little campfire and a sing song.
Yeah, we're gonna make some camp right outside of the I'm carrying a tent because I'm the roadie.
Why don't we just walk back and sleep in the inn? Oh.
No. Yeah, because it has burned down. Yes, ma'am.
There were other buildings we could have.
Tell you what, comfy. I'm going to cast this as we sleep.
The James Gordon of arrows.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that roll. What?
Pretty good.
All right, nap time.
So is this short or long?
We'll go for long, I think.
Yeah, I think we need to. I mean, I am beat up like I've never been beat up. So
yeah, same here.
All right.
So that I think half of us are on the edge of death.
Do we get all of our health back for that? I can't remember.
Yes.
For long, yes.
Long. Okay. Let's do it.
Okay. Nice.
And end of session, I guess.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Some quality camping, cooking some beans, ready to face the eldritch horrors beyond.
I would cook some chicken, but the problem is that Hawkins is awkward. Right there. Oh.
We call this situation Hawkward.
Why would that be weird? Hawkins is a raptor.
There's a point in. Okay, no, it's fine. It's fine.
Just
fine.
Eat the goddamn chicken.
It's the other white meat.
Eat the goddamn chicken.
Tale for the session.
All right, well, sounds good. We are set up for next Friday at 6 PBST. Does that sound right?
GMT.
AFK.
BST is over.
BBQ.
Very good. Mm-hmm. ROFL.
Are we on
LOL? Yet?
Now, here's an actual question for Odd and Pablo. Are we on EST or is it EDT?
We are on EST.
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 Very good. I've learned so much today. Thank you.
EDT finished on November 5th. 6th.
E-Y-O-B.
Whatever the Sunday was, which I think was the 6th.
I've learned, Blaze, that you have an inner evil character in you just waiting to be exposed to the night sky.
Yes.
Play some Vampire the Masquerade.
Oh, no, that's not evil. That's just, you know, teenage angst.
Yeah, it's just kind of Twilight. Edgy.
I don't know if you can call it edgy.
I don't. Yeah, it is hard. I tried playing it for a little bit with a group of people who were very happy with Crunch, like they were Shadowrun people.
Right.
And it didn't work out very well.
I mean, I played Hunter, which is sort of set in the same universe, but the GM wasn't really playing it like a Anne Rice novel, you know.
I am stopping the recording. Peace.